microphone buddy.
DJ Toomp. Yo, how y'all doing, man? We down, man, PatchWerk. You can turn it up, son. You can leave it really, man. Nice little bed. DJ Spinz on the ones and twos, you know. We got all the hottest producers. I feel like that matter that makes sense in the industry right now in Atlanta. They really concocting a new sound. They call it trap. I feel like it's more than that. I mean, we've been talking, and I feel like it's something that should break worldwide, man. Y'all need to understand where this sound came from. Today, we got Zaytoven, my brother. You hear the beat playing. That's the legendary DJ Toomp. He blessed us with his presence today. And we got some of the hottest new up-and-coming producers in the game right now. Childish Major. You know him. You don't even know bunch of shit, too much of the name. I'm going to let him introduce himself. DJ Spinz, the Young Jedi, the Trendsetter, you dig? TM88. Fashion icon to me, you dig? Sound God. Sonny Digital, one of my favorite producers in the game, is in the building. You dig what I'm saying? So we gonna rock out. And then we got my brother Cassie J back here too, man. He an up and coming guy. He next up, man. So y'all pay attention to what we gonna do. We gonna be here till about 10 o'clock Eastern, 7 o'clock Pacific. So let's do it. Let's get this Zaytoven, man. Yeah. Zaytoven, Zaytoven. Where you from, bro? Yeah, Mike. Zay lead the talk, man. You did. They ain't heard Zay's voice. They be hearing. They be hearing the beats.
Zaytoven.
Zay need tune, baby.
Yo, what up, man? Zaytoven checking in. Now, what you ask me again?
How long you been in Atlanta for?
I've been in Atlanta since the end of 99. You know, really early 2000. Came from San Francisco to Bay Area, man. That's where I started doing my beats. That's when I started doing the producing thing.
Yeah, that sound, you can hear the bass sound in the beats.
Yeah.
So from what I understand, you still play organ at church?
At church, every Sunday, every Tuesday, and every, you know, day in between where the pastor got to go preach somewhere, or they got choir rehearsal, or, you know, engagement.
I need to come to your church, brother. Come if I can on, hear man. You play that organ. What's the name of your church?
Life Abundantly Christian Church.
We got to come through there.
Y'all fall through. Everybody in here invited. Y'all come on through.
You did.
All right.
Zaytoven, the legend. Can you play us something? Just play us anything, whatever you feel like, bro.
When you say anything far as something new, something they, you know,
play
let me do the
play something classic.
Let me do something classic.
Introduce yourself.
Since we at PatchWerk, you know what I mean, the first time that I even knew that I was gonna, you know, take this music thing as serious as a career was I was in this exact room right here and we was getting this song mixed right now. The guy came up with Gucci Man. Back when him and Jeezy did the song, their first big song, their first big record was mixed right here in this room. And it made me feel like, okay, Zay, you know what? You can make it doing this music, man. All the time before this, I was just trying to sell somebody some beats for a couple $100. You know, it was like a hustle to me. Until I came here seeing this big old $1 million board and I heard my song and my music coming through it, it changed my whole mindset about, you know, being a producer. So my first one, I'm going to give y'all some classic, recorded, mixed, and everything right here at PatchWerk. So Icy, Gucci Man, featuring Young Jeezy.
Shout out to Curtis. Yeah.
Shout out to Kurt. Hey, well, hold on, bro. Y'all ain't got me tied in, dude. Hold on. Slow down. Wait, let's see what we got. Hold on. See, I got to play this off the internet because I'm on my laptop. I ain't even got this in here. But you know, it ain't no thing. Yeah. Okay, there we go. Crank me up. When you're trying and you ain't you bling.
Classic.
Rapping too, man.
Give us an auto tune, man. Let me say it.
We get a live Zaytoven performance. Boiler room, y'all need to pay for this.
And my wrist don't chill.
A quarter million? All I do is talk shit. You even had a couple grand for my outfit.
Call me Jesus the snowman. You get it? Jesus the snowman.
Yeah.
I'm iced out. Plus I got snowman. Let it marry me. Y'all niggas slow, man.
Slow, man. What the fuck, y'all? Dumbass.
I used to get 19 for a beat. Yeah. Call me genuine. The same OG.
OG.
I'm the shit, man. I need toilet paper. It's an air freshener, nigga. Fuck a hate. Yeah. These niggas don't like me.
Why?
I'm with the Gucci man and I'm so icy.
Back on the shit, is it the chain on my neck or the watch in my wrist? Maybe the ice in my ear or the bracelet. But she look like the type that can take a dick.
Oh.
Young Gucci Mane, don't kiss me, baby, you can kiss my chain. You gotta be a dime piece, just to look at the rocks in my timepiece. I come through when I drop top jack, a old school Chevy with the antique tag. My pocket's so heavy that I can't walk steady. Niggas copping ice, we done it already. Gotta go grill, but it's not from Eddie. I ride big sevens cause a nigga ain't petty. I'm icy, so motherfuckers snowed up. Little kids wanna be like Gucci when they grow up. Me, Jeezy, and Boo, we ain't hate pussy, nigga, gon' do what you do. Cause we icy, so icy, we icy, so icy. All these girls excited.
Ooh,
that was a big record.
You know what you could tell? You could tell I was from the Bay Area just, you know, by the sound of the music and the beat. Cause I remember when I first came and we was playing the beats for Jeezy, Gucci's like, hey man, this Zaytoven, he the best producer in the world, he this and that. And I knew from listening to the music that was going on down here that I was like, oh, he ain't finna really like this beat. So even when he played, you know, even when I played the beat, you can tell he was like, all right, that's cool. You ain't got nothing else. So, but you know, I was so stuck on the sound and, you know, it was the hyphy movement and everything back in the bass. So I'm like, nah, Gucci, we need to stay, we need to do this song. And it ended up turning to, you know, my first big song. Yeah.
That's crazy because that really concocted like the sound, I feel like, and what niggas was doing with that drop and, you know what I mean, just them highs and everything.
Yeah. It was definitely something, you know, me really doing my thing and making my mark in the game with my own sound. So, you know, I was proud of that. That was one of the songs that I'm most proud of. So I see. All right. What else? What we got to do now?
Play some beats, man.
Play some. You want some beats or you want some songs? I mean,
I want to hear a beat. I think the people like to know
a beat. Dang, let me see. Some beats, man. See, you got me over here. You know what? For the sake of time,
we got all the time.
Oh, okay. We got all the time in the world. Then. Let me see. See, you ain't even. I'm not prepared, but you know what? Let me find one. You know what? I'm gonna play another. You know what? I got a million beats. I'm gonna play something that's kind of
Familiar. Play some new shit.
Well, I'm gonna play something that's a beat that's familiar to the ears, so they'll know what this is. So y'all tell me what this is right here.
Zaytoven.
Beat coat.
been doing mixtapes with all the artists. Like, it seems like everybody coming to you like, all right, cool, I want to do a whole tape with you.
That's Zaytoven tape.
Yeah, what is that about?
I think it's really going back to the time, like, because, like, when Gucci first came out, when OJ the Juice Man first came out, when Young L.A. or Young Ralph, all the guys in Atlanta, I used to do all their music. Like, when they come out with a mixtape, it's Zaytoven and the artist. It's not no other producers on it. It's just Zaytoven did the whole tape. So after me and Future just did the Beast Mode, I think, you know, artists kind of respect that chemistry between a producer and an artist, so they going back to it. They like, okay, I need to do a Zaytoven tape. Everybody probably got a Zaytoven tape already. I work with everybody, and I always try to get multiple songs on them. I try to run up 50 songs with each artist, so it's easy for them to say, you know what, I need to put out a Zaytoven tape. I got, you know, 50 songs with them, and I keep feeding these artists beats. I make beats every day. I can't. What else I'm gonna do with these beats?
You know what? Another thing I found out about you is not, like, about the money. Like, a lot of producers say, pay me this, pay me that for the beat. Like, you really just feed the artist the beats, and whatever works for them works, and whatever doesn't work, you probably done gave about five niggas the beat. So
Yeah. Well, I just always believed in, you know, that's what.
I support that.
Huh? Nah, for real. I mean, I always, that's how I got my foot in the door, is because I used to pull up on every artist and have a beat CD with 40 beats on there and say, here, man, take these beats, rap on all of them, you can have them, they're yours. And I do that with everybody in the city, so you can't help but get your name buzzing when everybody in the city got your beats. And especially if they hard, people gonna start rapping on them and be like, okay, well, Zaytoven the hottest thing going, just for the simple fact he got all the beats around the city. Everybody got his beats.
Learn something, listen.
Yeah, because, you know, a lot of people want to say, well, now you got to pay me this for the beat and this and that. Man, I got so many beats that's sitting in my computer that probably, you know, I got to give them away. I'm not, you know, the money going to come. When you love to do this stuff, when you love to do music, that's the biggest thing. When you love to be a producer, you're going to do it day in and day out. And as a art in your craft, you want a rapper to get on this stuff. You don't want to just be sitting around waiting on somebody that got $5,000 to get this beat. You know what I mean? That beat for free might turn into $1 million.
The $5,000 song, they might not be able to come up with nothing to it.
I done seen it. I done seen every big record I done had then came from somebody that just had a beat that I gave them without them paying me nothing, but then they make a hit to it. So, you know, that's the way I've been doing it, man. And I like to be I like to be tangible, where a new artist can come and touch me. It ain't like Zaytoven too expensive, I can't run up on him. You can get in touch with me. You can see me. You can pull up to the city and touch Zaytoven. You catch him at the mall. And then, you know, with the right little budget, the right amount of money, or even if you just got the gift. If you got the gift, then it ain't going to take no money. If I hear that you got the gift, that's what I did with the Migos. When I first met them, they didn't have the money to come pay me. It's just I seen that they got the gift and they were stars. So that means I'm finna spend my time and my talent to work with them, because I know they finna blow up. So then that's the rebirth of Zaytoven. It's like these guys give me life every time they come back out, especially the new artists. I've been in this game over 10 years, and I'm still treated as like a new producer. That's because I'm staying, you know, I got to keep my fingers in the mud.
And another thing, you keep your hands on the new sound, too. You got Cassius J back there.
Yeah,
bringing Cassius up. He's been getting a lot of placements.
Yes,
so
sir.
What do you think about, like, what Spinz and what Sonny and TM and Childish been doing?
You know, they the one that keep me motivated, because I'm competitive. So when I hear TM or Sonny going crazy, I remember when Sonny came to my house the first time, and I was like, man, that, I don't know. That stuff ain't going to work. That man came up with a laptop, no keyboard, no drum machine or nothing. And he making the beat just on the laptop. So I'm like, okay, that junk ain't finna work. But then he be the hottest thing in the streets or the hottest thing on the radio. It made me competitive again. It made me be like, okay, wait a minute. I want to come back. I can do that. I can go hard like that. And see, they got them new sounds. They came in with the software, man. They made it hard for me. They start making it hard for me because I got the old keyboard. I got 10 keyboards at the house, a drum machine.
You got a real setup.
I got the real old setup.
MP.
The signature sound, but then they come in with this new stuff and it be like, well, dang, bro, they killing me like that with what they got. So it just, you know, it motivated me to really get back on top of my game and, you know, and step up. Now I'm collabing with all these producers. Like, you know, it's a blessing that, you know, I'm still to be able to be mentioned with these guys, and then these guys still, you know, we work together. So, you know.
Keep you fresh.
They keep me fresh, man. They keep me going. Man, don't do that, son.
No, you got your sound,
don't
though.
Don't do me like that, bro.
No. I'm saying you got your sound, though. You know what I'm saying? So when niggas come to you, though, like whenever we come to you, we know.
We want that sound.
I'm telling you, we look at you like a legend, bro.
That's
I'm telling
up,
you,
we
in L.A., we talking about, yo, we need them Zay keys right quick,
hey,
bro.
Man.
Swear on everything,
that
bro.
What's up?
Like yeah, on everything, though, now. For real, though.
Y'all don't stroke me up, man. Now. Don't stroke me up too bad, now. Man.
It's real.
I was telling D. I just told DJ Toomp the same thing. I said, man, that's so crazy. Even all my big songs right now to this day is still made from the old equipment. I got the new stuff. I got the new plugins. I just ain't made no, like, ain't nobody blowed up off none of them beats yet. They still rapping on the old beat. So, it is what it is. Yeah. Huh? I got to do it.
About to say.
Huh? Yeah. Hey, wait, man, we got to do it. So.
You got it sold up.
Nah, I don't do that.
Since Sonny got the mic in his hand, man, we gonna get to the damn to one of my favorite producers. Damn, he coming all time right now, man. That man got hits. He's so damn eclectic.
I'm chilling, bro.
You dig what I'm saying?
Yeah, I'm chilling. What's up, man?
So, where you come from, Sonny? Like, where was you born, and what brought you to Atlanta?
Hey,
Bankroll.
My boy just popped in. Hey, Pretty Boy Tank.
I was just talking about all these niggas in here, man. Everybody.
Where you from? What brought you to Atlanta?
Well, I was born in Michigan, but I was like raised out here though. I was like literally like born out that motherfucker though, and just
part of Michigan.
Here. Saginaw.
Detroit. I'm from.
You did. I was in Saginaw, man. That's where my fam at. You know what I'm saying? And so. But I was in Detroit, though. Detroit show love, too. Major love.
What you feel like your first big break was?
Rex on Rex. I know that was. You know what I'm saying?
Go ahead, man. Go ahead. Give him the classic, man.
Oh, man. Hold on.
The birth.
I ain't even had a classic on here. I got to find it now.
Spinz got it.
Oh, yeah. You
no,
two
Spinz
got
it.
Spinz got it.
Spinz got it.
This is a new computer, man. So I had to wipe all this. I had to wipe this shit. Well, not wipe this shit, though, but put everything back on here, though. And
one thing I need you to do, Sonny, I need you to get, like, the hardest beat that you feel like you have that ain't nobody rapped on.
Oh, no, I got a gang of those, man. That's easy.
That's hard
easy.
To ask.
Like Zay just said, niggas got beats for days now. I think right. we got more beats than rappers around this motherfucker. You know what I'm saying?
Press a button.
For real. And I think another thing too is like it's some beats that's just good for listening purposes. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes it ain't even about a rapper getting on them though. You know what I'm saying?
Shout out to Rico Brooks, the OG in the building.
Got that top hat.
He done built a lot of these
man.
Young cats. You dig what I'm saying? You ready? Go ahead, run the spin.
Oh, you going, bro?
Hey, turn up.
What you got? Get brave while I'm talking on the phone. Spend money when you're running this show. Real street niggas ain't no clown. We at the top where we belong. Brand Lee Rose ain't for a song. Smoking off the dollar, I'm strong. When the club out to hear this song. We got rinse on rinse on rinse. I'm geeked up off them bars. Got a car, I ain't even got a park. No key, push button, start. Seen a dime, I won't get hard. Got a hoe that need a green card. Send my dog, but I don't even bark. Got a bite and it sweat like sharks. When I hit, I'ma knock out the park. Trap beat so goddamn hard. Got cook, got lane, got bar. Got remake, hard to scale. Got brick, don't need no scale. I'm plugged in with the mail. I'm part of the cartel. Got re-rock, ain't no clean. C200 for a knee. Then fuck it all up on jeans. I'm a true religion fiend. Got bands in the pocket of my jeans. Need a key, stay away, I lean. Remethazine fiend. Stab on Sprite and lean. Got campaign going so strong. Getting brave while I'm talking on the phone. Spend money when you're running this show. Real street niggas ain't no clown. We at the top where we belong. Brand Lee Rose ain't for a throne. Smoking off the dollar, I'm strong. When the
club out of here this time. We got racks on racks on racks. The going cost on ice. Designer on my mojo. I live in the spotlight. Fresh green nigga ain't no flout. Young bitch gotta keep that route. I swear I got gated you niggas. I'ma need me a round of applause. Bravo, 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 bravo. Got 100,000 on worth clothes. I'm froze on cold. I keep me a big bang bro. I ain't tricking off on these hoes. These hoes bringing me they soul. I'll never sell my soul. Cash out on all these cars. These foreign, foreign broads. Got a nigga living in the stars. I'm on my way to Mars. Got Keisha, Pam, and Nikki. They all wanna do a menage. Ain't one free band, free bands. We never got a goddamn flaunch. Got campaign going so strong. Get brave, let's take another.
I'm gonna tell you something about this record. This record personally changed my life.
Sonny Digital,
you changed my life with this record because I was working with an artist at the time named Future, who had been the hottest dude to me in the city. And when he caught this record, it went to the radio and it went.
Bro, that record motherfucking really like shifted everything in Atlanta.
It shifted the sound of the industry.
I feel like it opened up a whole new door and shit, though. You know what I'm saying? Because it was like everybody was coming through. Everybody was new. It was a new sound. It was really just everybody just really tripped on the hit, though, for real.
Niggas started putting auto-tune on their verses after that song.
You did.
Legend started
putting auto-tune on their verses. I handled all my paperwork in that room over there with the racks on, man.
So speaking of Patchwerk, like, you know what I mean? This is a home for everybody. Like, everybody caught a hit in Patchwerk pretty much. So you did a lot of business here. Tell me about that.
All right. Well, I mean, I made my first real, like, bag here. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to Chubby Baby.
Shout out to my
boy B Stacks too. He was really out here spending the bag with me a long time ago though. But Patchwerk, I fucks with it out here, man. I know when I'm coming here, I'm making money and shit, man. Motherfucking. But if you here and you working and you trying to do your thing, man, you're gonna start in that little room over there probably. Actually, it's a smaller room than that downstairs now. Shit, you probably start down there now. Shit, you understand?
But you can make some money in that room though.
I done made money in that room. Don't get it wrong now though. But that ain't my preferred room though. I'd rather make money in this room.
You did.
Yeah, for real, man. I'd have made money in this room, too. I'd have made money in all these rooms, bro.
So you broke a lot of artists. Like, a lot of artists, like, their first hit came from Sonny Digital, as well as Spinz. We're going to get in that in a second. But lot of artists, you done broke a lot of people, like, from Future, YC. YC not here no more, but Future gone. I'm sorry. Did I say that? who else? McConan. McConan caught his first major number one record with you. You know what I'm saying? Like, tell me about some of the people you broke.
I don't think it's so much about the people that I broke, though. I think it's more about what we did, though. You know what I'm saying? I mean, you gotta understand. Like, it ain't like we giving hits to people that ain't already had hits, though. We giving hits to people that never had hits before.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So that's a big difference from giving somebody that's not. You know what I'm saying? Like, we just keep on doing it constantly. Like, you know, we can do it with this person, that person, this person. Like, we keep on doing that shit over and over again. And it ain't just me though. It's like how we hear, it's like a collaboration of like everything. You know what I'm saying? Like, even from Spinz though. Spinz, like, to be for real, Spinz was the nigga that was telling me like a lot of my songs was gonna be his before they even came out, cause he was in the studio like with
Spinz
a lot
got
of
the ear.
Yeah. He was calling every hit like back to back. I was like, at some point I was like, man, I can't go against the grain, shit. This nigga calling everything, you know what I'm saying? But shit, I mean, I feel like it's easier to work with them new and up and coming artists though too, cause they more prone to like listen to what you say. You know what I'm saying? Not saying that that's how it should go though, but sometimes when you got people that already had previous like success and shit though, it'd be a lot of like ego shit going on. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But when there's somebody who ain't never had none though, then they gonna listen to whatever it is that you say. And usually what you saying, being the producer a lot of the times, and the people that's actually doing the technical shit, is right.
Yeah.
You understand? Because at the end of the day, if you in the studio, you in the studio with producers and artists, and like, I'm pretty sure you in the studio with Gucci and Zay. I'm pretty sure Gucci always asking Zay what he thinks about this song. It's like the last call is always gonna be the producer. Like, you gotta approve it with him. You know what I'm saying? Even though that's not generalized to the fucking public and shit though, that is what always happens though. Like, well, a lot of times, like when you in the studio with somebody actually working with them.
That's how I feel.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
When the producers in the room giving their input, that's when the hit records are made.
Yeah, that's when the hits are always made, you know? You know what I'm saying? Like, whenever the producer, or at least that's how it's working now. That's how we about to make it work. Shit, you know what I'm saying? It's gonna have to work like that, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. Speaking of new artists, I want you to play a record for me. Can you play that Camino record?
I can. I play that record, but I want to play some. Another thing, too, let me put it like this. Let me tell y'all something. Even though I am a producer, I don't plan on ending my career as a producer, though. You know what I'm saying?
You're an artist, too.
It just, it's not even as an artist. That's just something to do. You know what I'm saying? It's, you get more money sitting behind the desk, I see now.
You did.
You know what I'm saying? Shit. You feel what I'm saying? You see fucking L.A. Reid, where he used to be a drummer? Come on, now he cutting fucking crazy checks to everybody, bro. Come on, man. Anybody can do it, bro. You did what I'm saying? So, like, with me saying that, though, like, shit, I'm starting from that point, you know what I'm saying? Like, as far as, like, getting in the business and everything, though, like I might not have that much production out right now, though, but me as a whole, the whole Sonny Digital brand is out there, though, because it's like I'm still got other ventures that's going and shit, though, too, because to me it ain't just being a producer, though, you know what I'm saying? It's about, like, taking advantage of being a producer, though, I guess, you know what I'm saying? And making yourself hot as possible, though, you know what I'm saying? So, like I said, with that being said, too, like, I'm really just, like, doing things that benefit me and my company and stuff, you know what I'm saying? So, like, and artists that I'm about to put out and everything, though. And that ain't no shade nobody, though, but it just gotta, it's like, for anybody that's trying to work, though, you gotta understand it's gotta make sense for anybody, though. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's gotta be some type of business at this point, though. Sometime, though. Not all the time, though, but, like, sometime, though. Like right now, like, I feel like right now we all in our prime and stuff. And, like, whatever we doing right now really matters and shit, though. You know what I'm saying? So, we got to make all the right moves and shit, though. You know what I'm saying? And so, like, I'm going to play some shit that I'm going to release through my label and shit.
I want to hear
from it. From my boy, Fat Man Key. You know what I'm saying? I don't know, y'all know him and shit. Y'all, you know, you heard him, right?
I think I heard of Fat Man Key, man.
Yeah, man. We just, he did. He had beer and tacos last night, though. But, yeah, man, let me see.
Key crazy. So this coming out on your label?
Yeah, I'm going to put this out through my label,
Sonny,
man.
Sonny the Executive.
Nah, man, look, it ain't even, it only,
hey, it man, might call be another it what it is, brother. Yeah, you're an executive. Hey, man. When you're releasing records, you're an executive now, brother. You're
that's what we trying producer. To do, man. Well, shit. Just look at how many people ain't making money off these songs that's going out, bro. Could be making money, too. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Stop putting out these mixtapes. Let's put out some.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Let's put out a couple of albums, man. Shit.
Something that's going to monetize.
Real, for real. Hold on. Is it plugged up?
Yeah, we plugged in. Boiler Room. Boiler Room TV. You tuned in.
I'm gonna play a little snippet of it, not the whole thing.
I gotta hear that Camino though before you get off too.
Nah, definitely. I'm gonna play that though, but I need y'all to hear this though before before that record's out, so we can always go listen to that. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, definitely. New and exclusive. You haven't heard this yet. Fat Man Key live on Boiler Room TV.
Sonny Digital. Hey, they hating on your hair, yeah. They frontin' on your hair, yeah. Who the hell was y'all when I ain't had none of hair, yeah. Now they got their hand out, they won't help, hell yeah. Hell no, hell yeah, hell yeah, hell yeah. Hell yeah, hell yeah, hell yeah, hell yeah. Hell yeah, hell yeah, hell yeah, hell yeah. Hell yeah, hell yeah, hell yeah, hell yeah. I'm like, hell yes. Try to fuck the money, but it won't oblige, hell yes. If them people try to blow like Mary Pies, yes. I mean, hell yes, huh. And a fail check, huh. Y'all see why, finally why they be on me. They don't want me, they really want my bucks. She plotting why she through. After I, hey, I tell her, keep the dust. They hating on your hair, yeah. They fronting on your hair, yeah.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
Can't give y'all too much of that now.
Hold on. Let me play y'all one more right quick.
Uh-oh.
Digital. I'm a dog, just like Gucci said. Yeah. Married to the money, I'm a newlywed. Right. And I'm faded, just like Boosie head. Ooh. I had bloodshot them bitches, ruby red. Ooh. I'm a dog, just like Gucci said. Ooh. Shut the fuck up, ho, just like Juicy said. Married to the money, I'm a newlywed. I'm still a dog, just like Gucci said. I'm a dog, like all my dogs. Catch the neck and hold her head south. Paul, hell no, can't fuck you raw. Catch a nut and dip like bitch, my dick got soft. Tryna get Karuchi headed, slang the wood like Juvie said. Make a movie with the red and dog it out like Gucci said. Being money newlywed, that's why that Thule in my pants. Pull up with them Uzis and some Goonies in a minivan.
That's another artist you broke. You and Q had a crazy project. Q went and got a deal and he's up through there now. It's just like you got a touch, Sonny. I don't know what the hell you got going on over there, brother.
All I can tell anybody, man, is to fuck with me.
You dig what I'm saying?
Yeah, fuck
all
with
you,
me,
all
man.
You labels with new artists, you need to break your new artists. You wonder why your artist is not popping. Guess what?
Call
they
Sonny
haven't,
D.
They haven't got a beat from a guy.
Is your artist not popping on your label? Call Sonny
Call
Digital.
Sonny Digital.
Are you on the shelf?
Call Sonny Digital. Digital. You ain't getting no show money?
Call Sonny Digital.
You dig what I'm saying?
Matter of fact, call the whole Atlanta, man. We really, the whole Atlanta giving life to the whole music industry. And that's real, man. I'm going to be for real, man.
Listen, I was in a club in L.A. yesterday, and all I heard was our music. It was all,
And shout out to Mustard, though. Mustard
going crazy. It's Mustard, Spinz, Southside, TM, and you. Pretty much all I hear in the club, period. You know what I'm saying?
Going crazy. Metro, too. Metro Sizzle going crazy. It's a lot of niggas out here really like doing their thing, bro.
That's what's up.
We the go-to guys, though.
All right, play my record, man. Please, one time, dude. This dude.
I got you. I got you. Definitely. Hold on. Let me look at it right quick. This record is pretty crazy, too.
It's pretty crazy. You're eclectic, brother. People got to understand how many different kind of sounds come out.
Hold on right quick. I got to grab it out of the email. Which one? Oh, the pot life shit. Yeah, that shit's hard. Actually, I got a beat that's like a little harder than that one, though. I'll play that for you right quick. That shit's pretty fire.
Oh, Sonny Digital. Racing into the bag.
Got multiple drives and shit.
I'm about to find this Camino record. I'm going to play it.
But you want to know why I don't like putting out them records either, though? Because people don't really like pay attention, the necessary attention to them that it needs, though.
Well, it makes it more organic when you put it out and the people gravitate to it. You kind of want that. Sometimes.
They do. I mean, I understand that, though. But it's still like, man, like, nigga, y'all been asking for different shit for a very long time. You said y'all tired of the shit we been doing.
I wish y'all would have let me put that record out. It'd have been a benefit.
If it was up to me, it wasn't up to me. if it was up to me, bro, nah, I could have, man. Like, it's so many things. Like, you got to understand. I feel like, see, a big problem, like, with me and, like, my business is that I feel like my people look at me as if I'm one of their friends, too. You know what I'm saying? And so it's kind of like they don't take it, like, as serious, like, how they're supposed to. If it was a white dude or something like that cutting a check at these fucking places and shit, though. When it's me, they ain't fucking with me, though. When they're one of them fucking, them big dudes that want them labels and shit, though, they be hopping on that, though. It is. But, I mean, it's like, shit, we showing more results down here, though.
Period.
You know what I'm saying? We showing more results.
Y'all in them big, expensive studios.
You know what I'm saying? It's kind of like, you know, you trading in everything that you about to spend to go sign with them, though. What you going to spend with us, you know what I'm saying? Or what it's going to cost us, the same thing you going to go... They gonna get you and shit though, but shit, you fucking with us, we gonna get to you off the love and shit.
A cool factor with dealing with y'all, because you gotta think about it. When I buy a Spinz beat or when I get a Spinz beat and the Spinz loves the record, guess what he's gonna do? He's gonna spin it on the radio. He's gonna spin it at the clubs. He's gonna tell all his boys to spin it.
You understand that though.
When you get a record, you feel like it's hot. You're gonna Instagram it. You're gonna put it on Twitter, and people follow you, and you're gonna make the taste. You're a tastemaker. You dig what I'm saying?
Of course, but you understand that though,
yes.
Because you with us. general public don't understand that sometime, man. Not all the time though.
They will one day. Let me play one of my favorite new Sonny Digital.
Go ahead, bro. I see you got pulled up.
You're gonna hear this. Beautiful record to me.
Yeah, that is pretty crazy.
You did your thing, brother.
Thank you, I appreciate you.
Different kind of sound. Like people expect the trap. They wanna, they wanna go. They wanna sell dope and they wanna cook up to your shit. But they ain't know they can damn go make love to the music.
Yeah, you did, man. Good intro.
Okay,
good intro.
All right. Okay. All right. Intro. T, I'm just gonna damn take the room over now with the sound.
That was a great intro. You should let that keep going, man. Nah, go ahead, digga shit. All right.
So look, now we're gonna introduce the young track monster, man. TM88. This man.
Hey, man. Like
concocted a sound. Him and his brother Southside, 808 Mafia. They went crazy.
Man, where he at?
I don't know where Sizzle at, man. Sizzle damn.
Balling.
Go get some money.
Somewhere balling.
He somewhere get some money. You know that.
Going crazy.
TM88, man, tell us where you came from.
Miami, Florida, and then moved here when the Olympics, and that been here ever since. Going crazy as a young nigga, you know. Before the music, I wanted to do music, just going crazy in my head. Basically
from Southside,
came from Miami. Yeah, from the South Side of Atlanta, Clayco, Riverdale. Me, Waka Flocka, gang of other people.
So you came up under the whole Brick Squad movement and all of that when that started.
Yeah, that's when I got my first chance, you know, to really show like what I can do. R.I.P. Slim Duncan, he gave me my first shot, you know what I mean? R.I.P. him, but you know what I mean? Waka put me on his album. We actually did the song at PatchWerk.
That's crazy.
Yeah, my first song ever came from fucking PatchWerk. Can you
believe
it?
That's what I was talking to Prophet about. We're gonna talk.
Yeah.
We're gonna talk about that now.
All that money you got now.
For real.
We know what's going on.
Well,
the mogul.
So it went from the Brick Squad stuff, and then I feel like your real breakout stuff is when you start working with Future.
Future, he gave me an opportunity to, actually, you hit me up on Twitter, and I was actually working on a FBG pack, and I was like, man, how the fuck can I get this shit to Future? Like, and you end up hitting me up like 2 days later, sent the pack. Future did like fucking 10, 15 of them bitches in 2 days. So like, that was like, I don't know. Future, he kicked our career off to like a whole nother level working with him, but. Him, Waka, Gucci, who else? Fucking
A lot of new guys.
Yeah, a lot of older rappers. I salute them. Project Pat. A lot of, old great talent.
Play something you feel like was a big record for you?
I'm gonna play that the shit off Walker album.
This is your first record you did in
the Patchwork. First one ever, Patchwork.
Shout to Curtis.
Hold on, trap. Talk TM shit one more time. Please, my nigga. Squat.
Hey. Fuck with these niggas. Nigga overseas. Nigga overseas. Nigga overseas.
Nigga talking
crazy, man. Fuck with these niggas. 808
Mafia.
Classic, Waka Flocka.
Classic,
yeah.
Classic.
Yeah, man. That shit used to shut the club down, bro. Like, crazy.
Tell me about them days, them Brick Squad days. Y'all used to just go and just beat everybody up every day, man.
They beat everybody up, but you know, I'm in there fucking with the bitches. But hey man, I be cooling, bro. But you know, Waka, he did his thing. You know, a lot of fighting, a lot of everything, but. A lot of positive shit came from that, you know what I mean? All the music, you know what I mean? Of course, Waka got a lot of success in the music as far as hip-hop and EDM.
Y'all
shout
got a lot of people mimicking y'all sound now, I feel like.
Yeah. Everyone in here know that shit. But, I mean, it's like a... I mean, I guess it's like the early 90s where, you know, when you make some shit, everybody tend to gravitate to that kind of sound or whatever, like from Teddy Riley and all them great people or whatever. But I mean, I look at it like, I mean, it's an accomplishment. Definitely. I mean, I don't get mad about this shit, bro. Like, just keep making music.
Mm-hmm. What else you got? Play something else.
I don't know if y'all heard Danny Glover. Me and Southside made this shit.
I ain't heard that record before. How'd that sound? This is actually Thug's second hit record, his first. I couldn't even say.
Yeah,
it was because he had records in the streets, but it was like before Stoner, and then Danny Glover really is what kind of catapulted him. Go ahead, play.
Yeah, a lot of people didn't really believe in Thug. You know, me, Spinz, and then a lot of us were working with a Metro.
Now, you know what? Actually, let's go all the way back. Let's go back to the dark days. It was a time where Thug really didn't have anybody behind him. Gucci went to jail. He didn't have anywhere to record at. And y'all had Dark like popping, so y'all brought Thug over there and had him like.
Oh yeah! Shout out Sonny and Spinz for bringing me up there, and Metro, Cam Kurt, for real. Shout out Cam Kurt.
So what was that? What was those Dark days like?
Fun. I mean, you couldn't tell. It was just a lot of music, a lot of drugs, girls, studio shit,
and play. Something that came out of that session.
A lot of shit came from there, but this also, you know, the little Kill Bill tag that we got, it's like one of the first beats that hit major for the shit to come out, so. Play it.
Okay, boo, I love her. I'm a saver, yes, I Danny Glover. I'ma call my poppin' for her, fuck the mother. I paid them a mile and then they kiss each other. I'm from LA, but I got keys to the city. I fuck it, I suck it, I
beat it down, then she beat me to the ceiling. Stolen my lifestyle. I'm living too well. I can't even make you proud. That money keep her around. In love with her head, I can't turn it down. Can't wait for my time to come back around. She see that you don't got little Haiti style. Plus, I just see Snoop on girl going wild. I just bought a billion and the bitch came with it. Young woo. Rich nigga hit $1 million. Ballin' in New York like a motherfucking Nick. You better have them rats you ever wanted him to spit. And everywhere I go, I got a pass like a staff. I'm going up top like a motherfucking lab. 357.
Big record for Thug.
And yeah, we actually put Nicki Minaj on there too. Shout out Dash, Propane, and Gene.
Yeah, Gene Nelson. Gene Nelson, big homie.
Yeah, shout out them. You did. What's up? What's next?
Play what something we doing? Else. You know what? Play one of them Future records, bro. Like, you know what I'm saying? Y'all got great chemistry too, man.
Yeah, I want to play the Codeine Crazy. I actually was on lean when I made this shit, and it's crazy. No, I promise on my little girl. And I'm gonna hold on.
Unless you got a Spinz.
No, I got it. Yeah, we're working hard enough, man.
We're gonna go back around later on after we do the introductions. We're gonna play a couple beats the last hour. Just let everybody just give y'all some sauce.
Oh shit.
Eskimo, the coolest DJ in the world.
Yeah, pourin' bubbly, pourin' bubbly, pour that bubbly, pour that bubbly.
Oh yeah, this came out off the Monster mixtape too. Yeah, it's crazy.
We done went through too much. Yeah, pour that bubbly, train that muddy, train that muddy. We'll be covered in. Yeah, I'm covered in. I was duggin' it. I just lovin' it. That's for the muffin' it. That's for the other bitch. That ain't for you, dog. That's for them other niggas. That ain't for you, shot. That's for that other bitch. I'm going crazy about it. I'm going crazy.
Nah, crazy. That's why I'm livin' it.
Yo, feelin' bubbly. I'm drinkin' bubbly.
DJ Esco.
Think I'm my problems to drink out the bottle and fuck on a model, yeah. Out of my this now the carnival, this is a royal old Cartier, yeah. Don Perry, young, I get done from a grown, I can show for the round. I pull up with my rounds, I pull up out of town. I corrupt the town with them guns and them pounds. I grew up on the grounds with them villas and hounds. We order more bottles and fuck on my models and pass them around. I say everything triple time. Roll it APU, blow triple time. I just know the ones you call upon. I just had to pay my dog a bond. Looking at me like a triple threat. Every time a nigga talk a check. Smoke the cushion like a cigarette. Run it back to hear my internet. Celebrate like a championship.
Celebrate. Hey, that's TM88, man. The Track Monster, man. You got a lot of shit going on. What you got? Tell us some of the stuff you got going on right now.
Everything. I just feel good, really. You know what I mean? I mean, I got a lot of shit coming out. I just went platinum on Drake album. My first time going gold and platinum, so like in the same month, same week down there. So like that was a blessing. But I mean, it's a lot of shit, bro. If you tuned in to TM and what I'm doing, you know what's going on. I don't want to give out too much, you know, because I'm working on a lot of shit. But
all right, let me tell you,
I actually want to bridge the gap between Toomp and, you know, Polo. I mean, we talked about this shit a long time ago. Man, as far as the, you know, the podium shit, man, like the whole union. Yeah, I remember you brought it up at Shakespeare spot.
Which one are you talking about? That shit when I was talking about.
Yeah, we was in there talking about the producer union and all the, you know.
Oh, yeah, the union. Okay. Yeah. Okay. First of all, I'm Toomp, you know. Yeah, Southwest Atlanta. But, it was, okay, I had to remember exactly what we were talking about because I go running my mouth, man. We'd be talking about UFO shit and everything. I was speaking of how we should put together some type of union, especially your new guys, you know what I mean? And the good thing about it, what I'm noticing too, I didn't know that, now I'm noticing all y'all are from different cities. And honestly, that shit helped the A a lot. Cause I mean, think of how many you can really name that's from here, born and raised. Like me, Polo, Mike. It's only a few, you know what I mean? That's really still just banging. So, yeah, man, I appreciate what y'all brought, you know, and still bringing. That shit is crazy. But the main thing I was speaking of is I think it should be some type of union. And the way I brought it up, I was like, all right, man, I hope cats don't think it's greed, but I think it's straight up business. And I feel like how Zay was saying earlier, how we love this shit so much. We don't have no problem just, you know, come on, man, everybody got at least 2,000 joints in their hard drive, not to mention what's in the computer. So it ain't no problem with us. And, you know, producers, we the good guys. You know, we don't really give, you know, too many problems. We let our managers be the bad guys. Or, you know, we'll send somebody another wolf at you if necessary. But main thing, but let me get to the point. The main thing I was saying is how we should start some type of union to where when our music does get out, that, I mean, we should basically, all right, let's just say you put a song out, boom, you produce something, an artist gets it, next thing you know, it started catching. You haven't even done a split sheet yet because this shit happens so fast. This shit can really happen overnight, you know what I mean? So boom, it's on the radio. Next thing you know, it's on the charts. Still haven't seen a check. But guess what? Everybody's getting paid before the actual producer. You got the manager getting his, the DJ, who's on the road with him every night. You see what I'm saying? And the radio, the engineers, the video guys, everybody's getting paid before us. So I'm trying to put together some type of union to where even if we can just start getting something up front, or and another thing I'm speaking of is if, okay, if you're getting shows off this joint, we need to work out something to where every time you perform this record, man, we get some type of percentage. You know what I mean? Not like a big chunk of your show money, but shit, if you on a tour and you gross $2 million, shit, at least let us grow about 20,000 off that motherfucker, or 10.
That sounds fair.
You know what I mean? So that, and just imagine like right now, and just think, and all of us have the biggest songs on a lot of artists. So just imagine Kanye can't leave the stage without doing Good Life and Can't Tell Me Nothing. You know what I mean? And a few other joints. I mean, so and a lot of the artists that they produce, they can't leave that stage without producing those, I mean, performing those songs that we produce. So I think just to keep the producers feeling comfortable about just giving, you know, cats track from the heart like we usually do, it need to be something that's really covering our ass to where we shouldn't have to wait for a budget to open or you to get a deal for us to eat. If you getting $5,000 and $10,000 a night, and shit, we still trying to save up money to get a new Mac or a Mac because our PC fucking up. You know what I mean? So it's like, I was telling him that, yeah, we should, you know, put together some type of union. That's crazy. I be talking so much, I had to remember what we were talking about. Yeah. But yeah, I mean, how do y'all feel about that? Do that make sense? So you got some artists who ain't going to agree with it. They be like, oh, man, they tapping into our shit. We ain't trying to be on no 360 shit.
Nah, shit. Niggas like you just said.
Yeah.
The whole time that y'all doing shows, we got to wait for BMI to give us our fucking check like 9 months after that shit them fucking popped off and everybody, they didn't live the good life and shit. We like a whole year late living the good life and shit.
Yeah, there
you
go.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, so.
Like, for real, like. So, I understand, yeah. But
niggas don't worry about it. We got a good Christmas, bro. You dig what I'm
saying?
Yeah,
like, man.
We got to buy toys for kids and shit, too, man. You dig?
Come on, man. We got family. Take care of grown folks and kids. But, yeah, I'm glad you brought that up, though, man. That's just something, you know. And any other producers, you know, yep, in the circle who feel that way, man, say, let's spread it. And, you know, hey, stripping numbers.
The only thing is, though, it is a, like, it's like a yes and a no factor to it though too though. You know what I'm saying?
Because that's why I don't really stress it. That's, you know what I'm saying?
I'm not saying I'm not talking from my end though. You know what I'm saying? I'm all with the unity because I already know we work. When niggas work together or when people in the general just work together, you get more shit done. You know what I'm saying? You cover more grounds and shit though.
Yeah, like I say, we're good. It's just exactly. The artists gotta get it. You know what I mean?
Shit, the artists scared of that shit, bro.
Once
we create our clan and shit, and we get that shit together and shit, that's gonna be fucking, that's gonna be,
it's
hell
powerful.
Right there, you know what I'm saying?
So I'm trying to think of how to really structure that, man. I'm glad you just brought that up too, cause yeah, and it may take me to get with someone like Polo or another powerful, you know, guy who done put in some work, who the, you know, the label still respect or whatnot. But yeah, man, I think it's necessary, man. And that way you'll really just feel good about this shit, not just feeling like, all right, man, boom, everybody getting rich off this shit except me. You know, it happens, man. Everybody done caught some of that. You know, hey, man, we'll straighten you out when we get a budget. But damn, boy, you got that new goddamn phantom around this motherfucker. You feel me? So, you know, there's a little something,
DJ Toomp, man, the legendary.
What's up, baby boy?
Blessed us with your presence.
Glad to be here, man.
You kind of concocted this whole trap sound. Like when T.I. came out.
Yeah,
you know that, the word, we never heard the word trap before that. We knew what the word trap was. Trap was a trap door or something like that. It wasn't something that the world knew as a crack house.
Yeah, that's true.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, so it's not only a crack house. Like now, you know, everybody uses the word. It's like a mainstream word. The damn near you can put it in a dictionary and say, okay, it means this. It means this. And now, number five, the DJ Toomp term of the word.
Right.
You dig what I'm saying?
Yeah. But at one point, though, I was a little confused when this new trap came around. Because I was like, all right, what makes that trap? Because really what made our shit trap is the, you know, niggas speaking about being in a trap. And there's dope boy shit. You know what I mean? The element, you know, the most of the concepts on the type of shit that we do is street shit. You know, trap shit. You know, getting high or getting some bras, one of the three, you know what I mean? But when they came with the new trap, it confused me because I was like, all right, where's the artist? And what part of this do y'all consider as trap? Like, how can y'all? The EDM. And when they started calling it trap, I was lost. Yeah, I was confused like a motherfucker. Like, why y'all call that trap? You know what I mean? And I never did get it. So I always, like you say, I call it EDM.
I think what they did, where they just took elements of the urban trap sound and put it with the mainstream pop sound and just meshed it. That's where they got that trap EDM from. Yeah, meshed them.
Yeah, because I figure you can have a trap beat, but what made that shit trap is the
subject matter.
The subject matter. There you go. Bam. Yeah. So that's how I felt about it.
So let's play some original trap music, Spinz. You got anything that you know?
There he is.
Legendary
shit. What you know about that? What you know about that? Hey, don't you know I got a kid? Got a three when I chirp, shout a chirp at Louis Nelson. When I'm holding all the work, yeah. What you know about that? What you know about that? What you know about that? Hey, I know all about that. Loaded, ay, on the low with the cheese at. Fresh out the jet, hey, the jets where the cheese at. What you know about that? What you know about that? Hey, what you know about that? Hey, I know all about that. See me in your city, city pretty, know I'm shining, dawg. Riding with a couple Lamb bras and I'm China, dawg. Hey, you know how we ball. Ride in a shiny car. Walk in the Zana Mall. You know about me, dawg. Okay. Don't talk about me, dawg. Okay. And if you doubt me, dawg, okay, you better out me, dawg. Oh. I'm throwed off slightly, bruh. Oh. Don't wanna fight me, bruh. Oh. I'm fast as lightning, bruh.
You better use your Nike, bruh.
She know you don't like me, cuz. Your people's like them dubs. She see me on them dubs. In front of every club. I be on the bumbus. Gave every hoop a hug. Don't show me mugs. Cause don't you know I got kids. Out of three when I chirp, shout a chirp.
That right there was definitely one of them, but the main one I think that really had the true trap influence, the main two I would say, was Dope Boys in the Trap and Be Easy. Yeah, Shawty Red Dope told Boy, me Be yeah. Easy really got him really into changing some of his shit up. I was like, okay.
Shout out to T.I.P.
I got 545.
What's it, what you need, shout out, hey, ADDBD right here, shout out, hey, man, that noise too, shout out, hey, man, you can't get no better than it right here, hey, now, hey, well, nigga, get the fuck out my trap,
crack a key and crawl my knee and do it 50 more times, quarter go for 5.5, go for 9, still in the trap with them breakdown dime, hit me on the hip or anytime, I don't mind. And drove for the daycare. The dope gang still strong like Pippin ain't dead. Heard what I said, I ain't buying no jail. This way 36 those more on a triple B scale. Yeah, look like you got that touching bus shouting. Stand around in my trap, I think you
shouting. Same nigga who told a cane getting paid in the trap. Paid a song for the niggas and the J's in the trap. For the dope boys in the trap, nigga. The thorn nigga, drawing dealer with the rat, nigga.
Tell you something though, man. It was funny, right? I can say, all y'all, man, y'all really, when we thought that we was bringing some 808 back in Magic Mike and the Luke shit and all the shit I did when I was fucking around in Miami, and when I brought it up here, even with the Lil Jon stuff, man, but you guys really sonically changed this shit too, man, because motherfuckers had to buy new subwoofers. Like, Kurt to tell you, shit changed, man. I don't know what the hell y'all figured out, but y'all start bringing out some different frequencies in that 808 to where I start putting more time. I'm like, okay, I got to start. Because if you listen to Dope Boys, it wasn't really, it was 808 in there, but it really wasn't that main element. It was more musical. But now, but if that shit had like the 2015 808 that y'all would be using behind that shit, oh my God, that would have been stupid. Yeah. I open the door. There it is. Y'all killing shit, man. But nah, that's yeah, sonically. That's why even when you play What You Know, I was like, boy, if I had some of that new 808 behind that shit, you know, tell them what it would have did. Yeah. Yes, sir.
You got something else, play something else, man. Play one of them Kanye joints. You got
Kanye? Oh, yeah, you got to play that. Hey,
what a piano that shouted. Y'all ain't never seen it. Boy, I play the piano and rap at the same time. Hey, let me show you something. Bop left and right like this. I'm 22 and a vet in the game. Say I'm super cool, still a threat at the same time. Rhyme about the times I invested in the pleasure and pain. Every aspect of the game. I'm the answer to your prayers if you're praying for change. So how dare you compare us and say we're the same? When I'm climbing the ladder, they stuck in the same mind frame. They accomplishments are nothing to gain. Well, I visually see a mighty your brain. Except this rose gold glow from my wrist and my chain. I entertain young n****s who slang like a picture, no frame. See it simple and plain. Bang, spit, flame, put to shame. Flow so insane, lyrics sick in the brain. Now you can't mention my city unless you mention my name. T-I-P-I-M-P, I'm the main. Hey, be easy. Hey, you don't want no trouble with me. Just be easy. The drama ain't nothing to me. Hey, be easy. Before you having problems, just breathe. Be easy. Hey, you ain't worth dying, believe. Just be easy. You don't want your mama to grieve. Well, mind your business, don't bother the G's. Sweat your stunt, but your friend to me. Behind the scenes, I'm behind you.
Dream, I could buy my way to heaven. When DJ I woke, I put that on a necklace. I told God I'll be back in a second. Man, it's so hard not to act reckless. To whom much is given, much is tested. Get arrested, guess until he get the message. I feel the pressure under more scrutiny. And what I do, act more stupidly. Bought more jewelry, more Louis V. My mama couldn't get through to me. The drama, people suing me. I'm on TV talking like it's just you and me. I'm just saying how I feel, man. I ain't one of the Cosbys, I ain't go to Hill, man. I guess the money should have changed them. I guess I should have forgot where I came from.
La, 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 la. Wait till I get my money right. La, 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 la. Then you can't tell me nothing, right? You saying something? You can't tell me nothing. You can't tell me nothing. You can't tell me nothing.
This time, I go for mine. I get to shine. Now throw your hands up. This my favorite tune. I go for mine. I get to shine. Now throw your hands up.
Favorite tune,
in the sky. And get pulled over in they new V. The good life, let's go on a living spree. Shit, they say the best things in life are free. The good life, it feel like Atlanta. It feel like LA. It feel like Miami. It feel like NY. Summertime shy. Ah. So I roll through good. Y'all pop the trunk. I pop the hood. Ferrari. And she got the goods. And she got that ass. I got to look, sorry.
Yo, it's got to be, cause I'm seasoned. Haters give me them salty looks. Lowry. Sticky told me, go ahead, switch the style up. And if they hate, then let them hate and watch the money pile up. I go for mine, I got to shine.
Now throw your hands up in the sky.
I go for mine, I got to shine.
Now you, like, looking at this Kanye stuff, like, you became the go-to guy after T.I. stuff. You know what I'm saying? Like, after you did that with T.I., in which... a lot of that stuff was recorded at the Patchwerk Studio.
Oh, man, small room, like the I'm Serious album. Like, a whole lot of this shit was done here, really. Yeah. Like, really, the first three albums. Well, I'm going to tell you, like, what really kept the magic with me and Tip, which was... He don't do it like that no more, but I beg him to do it like that. Is once he rap over the track, I used to get the track and go back over it and add more shit to it, really produce around what he's done, and then it's ready to go out to the world. But now he might get it, and the vocals and the whole song never make it back to me. Next thing you know, that shit is a mastering, and everybody wonder why it's not the same magic. Because that's great that you asked that, because I usually 90% of all the records that I've done for him, I usually go back and produce them after he lay his vocals. But it haven't been like that for the last maybe 3-4 albums. Yeah.
It has a lot to do with it.
Yeah, whole lot.
I got
yeah.
a question too. Can I ask a question? Can't Tell Me Nothing has a Young Jeezy ad lib, but yes, no sir. Young Jeezy verse. What's the story behind that?
It was supposed to have been the song I did on Jeezy's album called I Got Money with him featuring T.I. That was supposed to have been like a remix of I Got Money. So honestly, that was me. That was my first experience in emailing files back and forth. I didn't understand that shit. That shit was so foreign to me at first, because I was so used to, you know, sending off disc. You feel me? And Ye was like, hey, man, I just said this concept. You know, man, I want to do this remix to this Jeezy song. So what he did, he had the drums in there, and he was trying to build another song. But what happened? When Jeezy heard it, he was like, man, it's kind of, he heard that, that what threw him off. He was like, what's that irritating that sound? I'm like, bruh, that's what's making that shit dope. Like, you know, and then next thing you know, when me and Kanye, we email each other back and forth, like, the strings, and I come with the 808, then we just kept going back and forth. Then my man Mike, Mike Dean put the extra strings on top. Yeah, definitely. He's a fucking genius.
Mike Dean.
He's incredible. And that's what me and Kanye, we linked up, man. We linked up in New York. We started playing around on the ASR, and that's when he started seeing what else I could do. Well, he kind of caught on to my flavor when we was doing trap. We did trap music here, so Ye had about 3 songs on there. And so he kind of had caught a breeze of what I do, but once we linked up in New York, and then that's when he decided to come down here. To go on and finish the graduation album. We did most of that at Doppler. But we mixed, we mixed Good Life about 7 times. He wasn't satisfied. Honestly, the mix that we got out of here was banging, but I think he still wanted it a little bit grimy. I was liking the big, hard, loud, clean shit. You know what I mean? So, you know, that was an incredible project. That was fun, too, you know.
Working with Tip and seeing that a lot of iconic classic work is one producer being paired with one MC, do you feel like you've done some of your best work with Tip because you had the time to work with him and you had the time to really, you know, get closer to him musically and for him to get more comfortable with you musically?
Yeah, it's that. And then it's not having the pressures of the label hollering about a fucking release date. You know what I mean? That kind of gets in the way of great production and great music, period. When they keep looking at the watch, hey, man, you know, I'd be like, nah, we ain't finished with this shit. Stop being in a hurry to get this first single. You know what I mean? So that's what really made the graduation album what it was, because I felt I was able to do the same thing that me and Tip used to do. Like, after we did Good Life, I went back and did some more shit to it. Same thing, Can't Tell Me Nothing. Big Brother was the same. We just left it as is. We didn't even have to touch that. But I still went back and put some live guitars on top of it, though. You feel me? So it was more like, yeah, just being able to have an artist who really understand, really just sitting in.
What's up, boy?
All right, that nigga, good seeing you, boy. Hey, and just being able to really just sit in and with an artist who's a producer himself, that plays a part too. You know what I mean? That way I'd be like, hey man, you know, it's something else I want to do with that. He don't even ask. He was just like, man, just here you go. And he'll leave and come back and be like, oh, I love that shit. You feel me? So yeah, just so long as I'm dealing with an artist who understand that, you know, like, hey man, this shit not finished yet. Let's go in and put these touches on it. That's why I feel I can really truly say that I produced it more than I just gave you a beat. You feel me? Yeah. What, nigga? Yeah, that was real production too. I actually had a chance to produce that Nas joint. Yeah, that was some more work. I forgot we had that one in here. You're right. Yeah, damn right, I had the live stream section.
We're going to play one more tune, man, and just
let y'all understand
what's really going on.
Southside in this beach.
Sizzle, young Sizzle.
That's a case of, shout out Sanchez, my dog, but that's one of those situations like, hey man, we ought to get on Tip album. You got to do some shit sound like Toomp. So everybody think I did ASAP. That's not my record.
Wow. What about You
Don't Know Me? Yeah, You Don't Know Me for sure. My bad.
Say, hold on, that's not mine. Turn that off now. Thank you.
Even if you pull up the discography, man, right now on about five different sites, it's like, I'm like, nah, I didn't do ASAP. Yeah, they thought I did Illy too.
Right.
Yeah. So nope.
What's happening, Shouty? The King back. I know y'all miss a pimp, right?
Yeah.
But dig, there's been a lot of hate going on.
Okay.
So let me holler at you something.
Hey,
look at here, dog.
You might have seen me in the street, but Shouty, you don't know me. When you holler, when you speak, remember you don't know me. You save all the hating and the popping, pimping, you don't know me. Quit telling people you my partner, listen, you don't know me. Don't be a groupie, keep it moving, Shouty, you don't know me. Hey, I ain't tripping, pimp, the truth is really you don't know me. Yeah, you know they call me T.I., but you don't know me. You be hating and I see why, cause you don't know me. I think it's time I made a song for people who don't know me. I graduated at the streets, I'm a real OG. I've been trapping, shooting pistols since I stood on feet. So all you rappers acting bad, you gon' have to show me. You gon' make me bring a Chevy to a real slow creep. My partner's hanging out the window, mouth full of gold teeth. When the guns start popping, wonder when it's gon' cease. Chopper hit you in the side and create a slow beat. In the speculation, cause today we gon' see what's the future of a sucker who be hating on me. I ain't worried about the feds' investigation on me. I don't care that they at my shows and they waiting on me. I'ma keep on flossing, popping, long as Toomp is on the beat. Tell police, I ain't stopping, I'ma keep it in the streets. Contrary to your beliefs, I'm as real as you can be. So keep your thoughts and your feelings, Shouty, you don't know me. You might have seen me in the street, but Shouty, you don't know me. When you holler, when you speak, remember you don't know. Save all the hating and the popping, pimping, you don't know. Quit telling people you my partner, listen, you don't know. Don't be a groupie, keep it moving, shouting, you don't know. Hey, I ain't tripping, pimp, the truth is really you don't know. Yeah, you know they call me T.I., but you don't know. You be hating and I see why, cause you don't know. Hey, what's
you doing, man?
From the old to the new. 2015, DJ Toomp. You dig what I'm saying?
I'm making more with the bacon, so. Don't hate on me. You know where I'm at, though. Huh. I'm riding down Elvis Presley Boulevard. I'm riding down Elvis Presley Boulevard. Got the dog food, the salt, and the heart. You could tell them they can go and get the dogs. I'm riding down Elvis Presley Boulevard. Riding down Elvis Presley Boulevard. Got the boy, got the girl, and I got the heart. Tell them, they could bring the dogs. I got Priscilla. I got vanilla, boy, I got vanilla. I've been at counter, I'm stacking Skrilla. I'm riding down Elvis Presley Boulevard.
Got real longevity. You one of the only people that's been down producing in the 90s and still catching Rick Ross records in 2015 and shit, man. That's longevity. Can you explain your definition of longevity?
Well, it's wild because it's like I'm always get on with some albums, but I got to give me some hot singles back out there again. You know what I mean? really, it's about paying attention to what's going on around you. You know, if some producers may come through my studio, I'll be like, man, you heard that new song? I said, nah, man, I don't really listen to the radio. I don't really listen to nobody else. I'm like, bro, you know what? We ain't going to be able to work if that's your mentality. Like, you got to know what the fuck is going on out here. You know what I mean? And just study the game, you know? And really, you know, it's the first thing, man, is the love, man. You know, I was doing this shit when it was just a hobby, you know? And I started so early, it wasn't even really about production. It was about whoever the first motherfucker to learn how to work this drum machine. Because the niggas was looking at it like it was a spaceship. You know what I mean? Nobody really knew. It was doing more R&B. And I started like, man, I think I could change this, put some other drums in here, especially when I got my first sampling drum machine, the SP-12. And that's when I just started getting drum sounds from records, pulling them in there. And next thing you know, man, we just start, you know, the sound started changing down here. You feel me? Yeah. But we at the really started so early, the South really still didn't have a signature, like, identity. You know what I mean? It was, motherfucker was coming from everywhere. If you listen to that old Raheem stuff, shit, he was rapping like LL. Yeah, and then we started doing the bass. That's when I was fucking around with Loop them, and I learned a whole lot being on there, running around with Clay D and all them other cats, Magic Mike. I was down. I almost signed to Cheetah Records. I was going to basically start putting out albums like Magic Mike, but a lot of things happened with that to where I ended up moving back up here, you know? And that's when I, yeah, got with Lil Jon. We did Shawty Freak a little something. And then my mission was to really to find an artist, and boom, Clifford Harris popped right up, you know? Yeah. Yeah, it was beautiful, man. It's still working, you know? Been in more in the film lately, you know? Film real estate still. That's the thing too, gentlemen. Them checks coming, man. That shit's great. But boy, move that money around, man. Buy you some land, man. Get some property, dog. That's what this shit is about, man. When you get some assets, bro, you'll be able to take a break when you feel, man, and just jump in this shit when you feel like it. Because, you know, you got things moving. So, yeah, man, get them checks and move around with it, man. Just definitely keep, you know, stay smart with that bread, bro. You know what I mean?
Great advice.
Don't try to compete with nobody either. When you start competing, that's when you're fucking up. Do what you like. Whatever car, get that shit because you like it, not because motherfuckers expect you to see you in that shit. Jewelry, whatever you like. Do it. Get what you like. Don't get something in competing, house, anything. Don't be trying to compete with nobody else. Get what the fuck you like, what suits you, what makes you happy. So that's why you, all that shit maintained. So that plays a part in my music. Because if I was struggling financially, believe me, the music might start sound like that too, because you got to have your mind right in this shit. You know what I mean? And that's where management come into play. Like, instead of you calling and stressing yourself out, getting your high blood pressure, your blood pressure up high, cussing motherfuckers out about your back end. Nah, you got to have your manager to do that so you could keep continue being productive. Yeah, that's why I run to some cats who can say, man, I just do everything. Motherfucker, you should be calling Atlantic. They're not going to respect your phone call. You're the music guy. We the good guys, actually. You know what I mean? And I like to keep that clean face, you know. But if it's necessary, you know, you definitely got to put your nuts on the table and just let them know where you're coming from, though.
But they got to respect your nuts.
I got that switch, boy. You know what I mean?
They
got
to respect your nuts. If they hear your voice every day, they're not going to respect your nuts. They're going to say, oh, you got a little nuts.
Yeah, 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 exactly. Oh, I heard him. He sound like a real bitch on the phone, you know? But hey, know when I trip, like, okay, though, it's a problem. But whenever I really, when I step up and say something, that like, they get it right. They get it right. What happened? I missed something, man.
They gonna respect my nut sizzle. You, yeah, dig, man, what I'm saying? They
but gotta, nah, respect, man, my nuts. And just the love for the game, dog. You know, slowly getting back into DJing. You know, I used to do a lot of battle DJing, but now I'm starting to really pay attention to how to rock clubs and shit. But really, now it's getting to the point where I really don't even want to rock a regular club. I really want to just catch motherfuckers who want to dance and who just want to watch a motherfucker. You know, the art of DJing.
I want to have a house party and have DJ Toomp DJ that motherfucker.
That should be cold, man. Give me a.
Should be crazy.
Oh, you fucking with it?
That's the next Mobile Boiling Room. We're going to do the DJ Toomp house party.
Y'all can stand and watch me. You know, I play some good music, but then I got to show the artistry, you know, some of my battle shit, you know.
You dig? Spinz and Toomp going to DJ. Speaking of DJ Spinz, man.
Yeah.
This young guy, man, he took the trap sound, I feel like, and made it, you know, I feel like he brought a different layer with it when you. Brought like the Travis Porter stuff. People started it just got more into a party mode when before it was so serious. Sell dope this. People wasn't really going to the club and dancing. Then Travis Porter came out and they just brought the party back to hip hop. Tell me about that.
Man, first of all, I like the party. You know what I mean? Like, anybody who know me, you know what I mean? I might be a chill dude, but I love to have fun and I love good vibes. You know what I mean? So that's me as a person. I didn't come from a street background or just selling dope. You know what I mean? But I respect everyone. You know what I mean? So, and I more than that, I really respect good music. You know what I mean? So Travis Porter was just coming to my house every day. You know what I mean? And we was just kicking it. And we kind of just had an organic vibe. The first records we made was in the middle of my living room. No booth or nothing. So.
That's crazy. You came from, you came here to Atlanta from Augusta, right?
Yeah, Augusta, Georgia.
What brought you here?
Music. I had been DJing. I had been DJing in Augusta since 16 on the radio. I had a show down there. And then, you know, I wasn't making beats or whatever, but I met Techniques and I met Scream like early in my life when I was 16, 17, and they, you know, they always showed me love, and then Scream kind of took me under his wing when I got here. So after that, it was just like, he was like, yo, I got this club in Marietta, you know what I mean? You can start DJing at, and I'm like, shit, I'm in school.
El Pasano or something?
Huh?
Was it El Pasano? Which one was it?
It was before El Texano, it was Mariachi.
Mariachi.
You know what I mean? And that's where I met all these guys. I met Waka, you know what I mean, Chaz, and they just used to come to the club and act the fool every week, you know what I mean? But then eventually Waka brought Oh Let's Do It. And you know what I mean? I met Mike Will, everybody. They was in the club every week. You know what I mean? It was just like a little theme because, you know, they were from the South Side, but the North Side had the women. You know what I mean? So they was coming up there every Monday, every Thursday, every Friday to see that, to get away from what they was doing.
So a lot of records broke out of that.
Man, what? That was the start. And then from there, went from Texano. I started DJing the Libra. I started DJing Obsessions, which used to be Chocolate. You know what I mean? All that shit, man. And so it's just like, shit, when I got up here, like, I'm from Georgia, but I just appreciate Atlanta for embracing me, you know what I mean, and being that hub for, you know what I mean, my music. And it didn't start from me just making beats. Like, it was like me actually just loving music, and this where I ended up at. So
play one of them early records, man.
What you gonna hear, man?
Some of y'all did in the living room, man. It went big.
All right, yeah, we made this in the living room.
You dig what I'm saying? Hit records made in the living room. Real producers. We use Patchwork sometimes, but sometimes we can use the living room.
It would have been better with Patchwork, but it's all good. Better.
I was walking through the crowd and I seen her with a team. I tapped her on the shoulder and said, girl, I like no jeans. I told her, go shorty, shorty, go shorty, shorty, go, go. Go shorty, shorty, go shorty, shorty, go. She was dancing like a stripper, so I had to throw some one. She winked her eye at me and said, it's time to have some fun. I told her, go shorty, shorty, go shorty, shorty, go, go. Go shorty, shorty, go shorty, shorty, go.
Now you the ultimate cheat code, Spins, because if you come and get a Spins beat, the thing about Spins, Spins down 5-6 days a week. He's in the club, fucking, he's on the radio station 2-3 days a week, fucking satellite radio, Atlanta radio. So Spins fucks with you. If he likes you, it ain't never been about no money with him. It's about, okay, the sound, the sonic, the organic. If he fucking with it, you gonna win. If you fuck with Spins.
Man, that vibe, man. You know what I mean? Like, Toomp said some very, very, like, great words when he said, you know, I mean, and Sonny too, like, when you make it, the money gonna come. You know what I mean? You make good stuff, the money is gonna come. So I'm not just out here like, yo, I need this, I need that. Like, let's just make some shit, and if it pop up, you know what I mean? If I feel like it's gonna be worth my time, we gonna do it. Like,
yeah, and I appreciate you for that, brother, because, you know, you really are a real like innovator, and you, like I said, it ain't about the money with you. Like, you just come out and just do it for the culture.
Absolutely.
So another one that really blew you, just like Sonny, you blow a lot of artists up too. You touch somebody just like you did with Travis Porter, all that first stuff. You got Cashing Out.
Yeah, that came from the club. Like, I was doing them sessions every week, and Cash Out would just be there early, like just early. He'll come kick it in the booth, roll up, you know what I mean, just kicking it, buying drinks, whatever. And he's like, we need to get in. We did one record. It was probably about 6 months before we did Cashing Out. Then we got back in the next time, like 6 months later, and the first record we made was Cashing Out. So, yeah, that Cash Out, salute.
Gonna play that right quick. Yeah, man, Spinz put that work in. Spinz broke down everybody. If you're a new artist in Atlanta, Spinz ain't working with you, you're probably not gonna pop. Here's my cheat code. Dead for real.
I think this the video version. Hold on.
My diamond top for me, they say, why can't I meet you? G5, I'm high in the sky, ho, I can't see you. Got a condo on my wrist, girl, I'm cashing out. Got a condo around my neck, girl, I'm cashing out. 36 hoes, so round, round with that needle. My diamond top for me, they say, why can't I meet you? I got Versace all on my back, these hoes all on my back. All on my back, cause they know I'm moving that back. These Louis all on my face, hope he'll stay up on my waist. Plus it ain't on me for nothing, so please don't make me catch a case. Cause bitch, I'm bout it. Me walk around with no check on me, psh, yeah, I doubt it. Yo girl ain't finna leave with me, psh, yeah, I doubt it. And I'm like, what the hell they talk about? And if I got it, I buy it, cause boy, you know I'm cashing out. 26 hoes all round, round with that.
Yeah, DJ Spinz, that was a big one for you. That was one of your first number ones, right?
Breakout, first number one.
Yeah. So, like, Spinz, you've been, like, a go-to guy, you know, for a lot of producers, not just here in the city, but a lot of around the industry, like you playing the keys and you coming in and saving somebody's drums or something like that. Like, I've seen you come in and the unsung hero on a lot of records. Tell me about that.
Man, I just want to play my position, man. Like, it's and I say this all the time, like, and sometimes even to a point of just putting me, maybe belittling me, but it's like, it's not about me, bro. It's like a band is a group of or a group of instruments, you know what I mean, playing in sync. So I just want to make that shit right. If we need Southside to make it right, if we need Childish to make it right, we need whatever. It's like, man, let me just connect the dots and put this shit in the right place. If you need me to play this key, cool. Like, let's do it. And let's make that shit sound the as good as possible, the best way possible. So I just want to simplify things and make it the best.
That's what's up. You got something else you want to play?
Since we in that range, shit, let's goddamn play the shit that was popping around that time, too, the 2 Chainz, the Riot.
Oh, yeah, this is a big one for you.
Woo! This is Spinz takeoff. He caught Cash Out.
Spinz, what's happening, man?
Start working with 2 Chainz.
Yeah. I told the whole squad. I say, damn right, that got it. Damn right, that got it. Damn right, that got it. That damn right, that got it. 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 That damn right, that got it. I say, lame nigga, be quiet. My lame nigga, be quiet. Lame nigga, be quiet. You in the prison of weird nigga. I say, lame nigga, be quiet. Lame nigga, be quiet. Like, lame nigga, be quiet. You in a real nigga presence. I eat your girl up for breakfast. Won't say you no extra. Say she fuckin' with me cause a real nigga's her preference. Drink like I'm from Texas. And you know I stay flexin'. And if you don't know, I go by Titty 2 next. I say, damn right, I got it. Damn right, I'm bout it. Click full of killers. Please don't get us excited. Yeah, we're smoking loud. So lame niggas be quiet. And if you fuck with us, we gon'
Hey, man, DJ Spins, man. You dig what I'm saying? Hey, man, he's an animal. You got a lot of new shit going on now, too. You actually got a top 10 record right now, don't you?
Yeah, yeah, me and my brother Southside,
man. Sizzle, man.
Young Sizzle in the
got
building.
The fucked up right now. I don't play that shit, man.
Currently constructing a backwood.
You dig what I'm saying?
My boy.
Always. Young Spin. We got to roll up one to two of them. Go ahead, play that commas, bro.
Let's get it.
Free nigga lie to a real nigga. That's just some shit that you don't do. I'ma stay rapping. That's just some shit that I'm gonna do. Fuck all the commas.
Southside.
Let's fuck all some commas, nigga.
DJ Spin.
Let's fuck all some commas. Do this shit around them. Yeah. Felch. Shit you said don't do. Fuck out some commas. Let's fuck out some commas, yeah. Let's fuck out some commas. Let's fuck out some commas, yeah. 100,000 to 100,000. 100,000 on 100,000. 200,000 by 100,000. A million is out of money shop. Fuck out some commas. Let's fuck out some commas, yeah. Let's fuck out some commas. Let's fuck out some commas, yeah. 40,000 to 100,000. 100,000 on 100,000. 100,000 by 100,000. A million is out of money shop. Fuck out the lumber. I'm hot like a sauna, yeah. The burner is on me. Can't play with that money, yeah. I'm fucking with shorty. I'm loving the way that she fucking me, yeah. Get no fucks, yeah. We don't get no fucks, yeah. Throw my cup, yeah. I just bought my plug, yeah. Full of the mud, yeah. Nigga get full of them drugs, yeah. Feeling real right, yeah. I'm on the same thing as Mike, yeah. Ball of ice, yeah. I wanna beat that dog like Ike, yeah. Fuck out the commas, yeah. Fuck out the commas, yeah. Let's fuck up some commas. Let's fuck up some commas, yeah. 100,000 to 100,000. 100,000 on 100,000. 200,000 by 100,000. A million dollars out of money shop.
Yeah, man, it's crazy. Y'all collab. Like, y'all don't, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's crazy. Like, producers used to just do their own shit. Like, y'all, like, really just sit down in the room. That's why I like this situation right here, because y'all just come together and it'll be four or five of y'all in the room. And it really don't matter. Just come up with a vibe and a wave. How did that beat come about? Tell me about that.
Man, we normally do cook-up sessions, me and Southside. So, like, we'll pull up. We might make four or five beats, you know what I mean, every session we do. And he pulled up on me one day. He was like, we got to go in for bruh.
I popped up on you one day.
Yeah, he popped up on me. You know, I'm always ready.
I'm
so
downstairs. Where you at?
Yeah, man. So we went in. This is the first beat we made that night. And it took probably about what?
10 minutes, 15 minutes.
Yeah, laid down piano melody, Southside went in on the motherfucker, goddamn, did his little 1-2, I came in, did my 1-2, history, took it to future the next day.
I ain't even see him no more. I went over there to help my boy with the beat. It was like, all right, I'll see you later, I'm gone. You can go on over there with future, I got to go, I'll see you later.
A week later, that was a week before Monster came out.
Now that was the day before.
Yeah,
it
might have been
Halloween.
The day. Yeah, it was like
that
right
shit like the day before it came out, like or 2 days before, some shit like that. Cause I remember I called Pro 2 and Pro, you were talking about something else though, and I was like, you heard Converse? He was like, oh yeah, I heard that too. He was like, he was talking about something else. Though. I don't remember what he was talking about though.
That's it.
It's enough for everybody, man.
Always.
I don't care if it's four of y'all on that motherfucker.
But we ain't like, hit a track. 10 deep. We don't give a damn.
Everybody, man.
10
man,
deep.
I had to get that through a lot of cats' head, man. Good to see that y'all on that shit, man. Cause it's, I love it, man. Man, invite me, whatever.
You invite us, you man.
That's what this was
saying,
for. This
man.
Is supposed to be a
invite
live cook-up session.
2%, man. Let me get that little two. Just a clap. If you don't like the drum shit, take the drum and make another one. Trying to tell you. Facts.
Young Boss, man, Southside, man, this man right now.
Bro, what's up, bro?
Got the streets fucked up, buddy. Like, this man. Motherfucker, like, first of all, Southside been doing this shit, and he done birthed a lot of these little young niggas and a lot of their sounds and shit. But not only that, right now, like, what you and Future doing right now, that shit is unheard of. Like, the whole 56 Nights plays in the club. How the fuck that happens, I don't know.
I don't even know. I don't even know how this just happened.
I know we had a conversation one time. He was like, man, just put it together. Just get
I was just finna say I got to thank my boy Pro, and I definitely got to thank my boy TM because I was gone. I was always on the road, so. And I was just, I'm so team.
I'm going to tell you a funny thing about you. You like a thief in the night. Sizzle would show up to four studios in the night, lay drums and 12 beats and damn leave, and then look up all the motherfuckers on the radio.
Yeah, that's how we got to do. We pull up, get the fuck on. What but I don't know, the whole future shit, is that's y'all too. Like, T went over there and pulled that for us, for the whole camp. You know what I'm saying? And I just was like, shit, because I'm not a friendly, like, real friendly, like, yeah, I'm going to come chill with the rappers. Like, no.
No.
I'm not. I'm going to ride around with choppers and the young niggas all day, still.
All day.
You feel me? Like, still to this day, but Future a good dude. Huh? But you set that up over there, bro. You know what I'm saying? You did, bro. Oh, nah, that's 100, bro. That's all I love. Yeah, you're damn sure right, but yeah, and that's my big brother. Yeah, that's my big brother. I can't, you know what I'm saying? He never turn him back on. We fight, we argue, but I love him to death. It ain't gonna never change.
You know what I'm saying? Y'all see that live on Boiler Room, baby.
Yeah,
for life, 808 Mafia.
Still pulling up. Don't get it fucked up.
Play me a 56 Night record, man. Play one of my favorite songs right now is that Trap Niggas. I was in L.A., nigga, and that shit went
I was stuck in L.A. for almost 2 months.
Right.
Yeah, and that shit was just so much love everywhere we went. It just was like, oh, they here. We here.
Sizzle pulling up in the damn double line shit. I'm like, how the fuck you get that from, Sizzle?
Hey, man, you know. Hey. Hey, man.
It's
gone. 808 Mafia. Times been hard, but the next still getting it. Yeah, rich niggas. This motherfucker. Huh? When you wake up before you brush your teeth, you grab your scraps, nigga. All the time you get down on your knees, she don't crowd, nigga. Fuck what you heard, God blessing all the trout, nigga. God blessing all the trout, nigga. When you wake up before you brush your teeth, you grab your scraps, nigga. All the time you get down on your knees, she don't crowd, nigga. Fuck what you heard, God blessing all the trout, nigga. God blessing all the trout, nigga.
Weighed 1,008 grams on the squat. I got a lowercase T across my chest. Your crack house doing numbers, then you bless. You move your mama to a crib from the Jets. It's so much, I can holler push on my bro. Praying 5 times a day to catch a plug. A few bean pies stashed in the truck. Shoot dice out there and sell dust. You loaded up, they talking shit, you gon' bust. Know yourself a million times, you don't give a fuck. Sold over a million dimes, hanging in the cut. Sold over a million dimes, you don't give a fuck.
Now I've heard 808 Mafia be described as one of the most prolific production teams and squads ever to hit the music industry. I've heard multiple publications describe y'all as that.
I mean, shit, we owe ourselves, bro. We out here working, but it ain't just us, it's all of us. You feel me? I got support from Spinz. I got support from TM. Support from Metro Boomin.
Definitely Metro.
You know what I'm saying? Shout out to my boy, too. That's my brother. Support from Sonny Digital. It's the whole mob, especially Toomp. Like, I done ran into Toomp so many times and just... I seen Toomp and Shake shit one day. He was like, yeah, I like your swag, man. Like, you be popping that shit. Like, you popping that shit. You know what I'm saying? So it's just, it's that Atlanta vibe. I just love the vibe of Atlanta, man. I love it.
I'll build the sound. Play something else, man. What other Southside classes we got, man? We got to pull up a Sizzle classic, man.
That's on. What's up, T? What you want to hear? Play. I want to hear something from like the movie, from like FBG the movie type.
Ooh.
Shit. Like, let's go back to there.
That chosen one. I remember Southside sent me this.
Which
beat
one?
We was in Miami.
On the illest. The illest motherfucker.
Hey, you know what funny about that chosen one? We was in Miami, right? This was New Year's night. We was about to leave and go to the club, and then OGUD was in the studio, and he had this Louis V chinchilla he was trying on.
Yep.
Talib Kweli was in the studio that night. I remember. And then he was putting his clothes on. He was putting on the sauce for the club. Future did like the first half of the song, and we left, went to the club, and came back. You know what I'm saying? It was just a vibe.
I just remember him blowing my phone up. AM2, he was like, yo, you got to send some beats. I was like, I ain't got no beats.
SZA don't give a damn.
And Pro was like, SZA just sent me 10 beats. I was like, I just sent you 10 beats. I sent Pro 10 beats, and the motherfuckers went crazy, all 10 of them. Like,
all
literally.
Them, all of them. I still got some of them, too, and niggas rapped on.
I told you, bro. It'll never be a crew full of millionaires like us. And global. Bought a fountain cause I always wanted one. Made a film with them bitches, ain't no one-on-one. Got this watch and this watch is like a one-on-one. All my niggas millionaires, it ain't just one. Have a few chains on, I don't have a one. Bought a few houses and I never sleep at one. And I can have 10 cars and I went drive one. And when you make it from the bottom, you the chosen one. Free band millionaires. The foundation. Turning into something. Yeah, I've been good at it. Love. Turn up. Rich nigga since birth. Louis V. Chinchilla. Bought a brand new Rover.
Driving like a four-wheeler.
Solid gold AP. Flooded out with them crystals. Shining just like Miley. Woke up in a new Bugatti. Free Lil' Kirkwood, young Trotter. Free my nigga White Boy too. I woke up to another baby. Now I spend that on Jimmy Choo. You got guns around you, nigga. I keep shooters around me, fool. I'm a young rich nigga from the bottom. I came up and I can't lose. Bought a fountain cause I always wanted one. Made a film with them bitches, ain't no one-on-one. Got this watch is like a one-on-one. All my niggas millionaires, it ain't just one. Have a few chains on, I don't have a one. Bought a few houses and I never sleep at one. And I can have 10 cars and I went drive one. And when you make it from the bottom, you the chosen one. Hey
bro, we from a different Southside, so you from the Southside. Your name's Southside, you from the Southside.
I'm telling you, man, we run the Southside, man. You know what I'm saying?
Give us your background. Tell us where you from. You know what I'm saying?
Like, I come from the Ratchet Crew. My boy Spinz had the party music. I come from the pull up 100 deep and beat the whole club up and make them high extra security.
So I would say you are a product of what Toomp started with the trap sound.
Oh, yeah. I'm definitely a product. We the new age of it. We the, I'm like I said earlier, I'm so team Walker Flocker. Like, that's my brother. You feel what I'm saying? Like, he found Tip. I sat with Walker and just figured some shit out. You feel me? Like, watch other niggas. Shout out to Lex Luger, too. Watch other niggas, and we here now. You know what I'm saying?
Let's go back to some of that 56 Nights, man. What you got? What's your favorite song on 56 Nights, Ben?
I ain't gonna lie. Shout out to my little nigga Tarantino. My favorite song, March Madness.
March Madness.
You feel me?
Yeah, let's play March Madness for Tarantino, man. Shout out, man. 808 Mafia is a motherfucking a problem. You dig?
The mob. You dig?
Dress it up and make it real for me.
Eskimo, the coolest DJ in the world.
Whatever that fucking man. 37 in Stanford. Spend a day to get my mind blown. Dress it up and go to NASA. 200 miles on a dash. Got a roll a pound up a gas. Switching lanes in the Grand Rapids. We the one that kept it cool with all these niggas till these niggas start acting. Shoot a nigga like a film in a movie, nigga gon' let them have it. We ballin' like the March Madness. All these cops shootin' a nigga tragic. 21 to live in lavish. Like I'm playing for the Mavericks. I don't want it for the bitch that might have made me fuck her even though she average. Dirty money in the cup, 45 by my good. We young nigga in the cup, take you out for some joints. It's countless money, no rush. I'm on the one way flushing. Loud pack smelling mustard. These fucking police can't touch me. These bogus police can't touch me. These fucking niggas can't touch me. Apply the pressure with the VVS. I drive the foreign like it was a ship. Drive the foreign like it was a ship. It up and gone and all set. Fuckin' Cooper like she Holly Berry. Future hinges, dirty spray, legendary. Dirty something in the sky for. Spill a day to get my mind blown. Dress it up and go to NASA. 200 miles on a dash. Got a roll a pound up a gas. Switching lanes in the Grand Rapids. We the one that kept it cool with all these niggas till these niggas start acting. Shoot a nigga like a film in a movie, nigga gon' let them have it. We ballin' like the March Madness. All these cops shootin' a nigga tragic.
You just, you gotta feel that record, bro.
Gotta feel that.
Like, man, he touches so many topics on that record from what's
hook,
going on today.
So many. If you listen to the hook, he talk about so much shit, and he dropped it in March, first of all.
Like, man, that record is crazy. Like, yeah. crazy. That record touch. A lot of records don't give me goosebumps. That record really give me goosebumps. Like, I just hear that, listen to that record and be like, damn, this shit really fucked up out here. Yeah. Real fucked up. You know what I'm saying?
Definitely, yeah. So what you got coming up, Sizzle? What's your plan? Where do you feel like you want to be when it's all said and done?
Shit, I just want to be stable, bro, and leave a mark in this game forever. You feel me? Like, we got 808 Mafia Records, me, Tim, and of course Propane, and a couple of more other people. We got a couple of artists we fucking with. A lot of people. I got Slug Mania, Tom the Ruler, Ethan Saatchi, Spiker, Snob Mob. Yeah, we got a movement right now. You know what I'm saying? It's a lot of producers. We picking through pub deals right now. We just, you know what I'm saying? We enjoying the life right now. That's it.
I got a couple meetings for you, too. We need to take, yeah, my brother.
Come on with it, baby. We ain't turning out no checks. You know that. Nothing.
Well, that's what's up, man. This brings us to the youngin', man. You dig what I'm
there
saying?
There you go.
The up and coming, man. Childish Major, man. He really, his first record, I don't know if that was, I know that wasn't the first, definitely wasn't the first song you recorded, but it was the first time I heard your name.
Yeah, for sure. That was it.
That you don't even know it. It went crazy. It's almost platinum now.
We praying.
So how old are you now?
I'm 23.
Okay, how did you get into making the beats and all that shit?
I started like making beats, just, you know what I'm saying, just fucking around, got FL Studio, but my introduction in the game was through Spinz, honestly. You know, we met, we both went to church in Augusta. Well, I was from South Carolina, but I used to drive to Augusta, go to church. Actually met him on a church trip. Niggas was in the hallways trying to get some. You know, everybody was like-minded, me, him, and C4. I went to school at South Carolina State. Spinz was out here doing his thing, DJing and, you know, all the hits. And I was like, man, seeing him do it, man, maybe I could do it. So I came, he gave me a shot. Yeah.
So go ahead and play that, man. That was the first Childish Major record. I'm like, man, who is this? Where the fuck he come from? Boy. Sound the Rocko. Rocko done burst a lot of niggas soon now.
This shit sound crazy. Flash it on me. You know what I'm saying? This $1,000 pair of shoes, you don't even know. This $1,000 purple lane, you don't even know. This $500,000 car, you don't even know. I came up from the bottom, you don't even know. My niggas all right with me, you don't even know. Got killers with me right now, you don't even know. This $1,000,000 watch, nigga, you don't even know. Got $1,000,000 crib, nigga, you don't even know. Ayy, that monster truck, sit tall as fuck, so big, can't even talk. Don't like snakes, keep my grad cut so low, can't even more. Sip done, period, look high, glow, no, we don't do more. It ain't PJ, no rosé for me, host don't even pour. Spence on tone for it. Button down Michael Kors. Always on like the refrigerator unplugged, then ho, you know it. AP and that P gate with a bright lean when on board. Got a masterpiece and a 41 millimeter, you ain't even know it. Keep the 45 in my pocket, I ain't gon' show it till I have to pop it, then you gon' know it. Damn, who shot you, they don't even know it. Hawks game, fucking Floyd. TV seat, front row it. Rocko the Dunn, CEO it. Ain't got a rapper, you know it. Nah. This $1,000 pair of shoes, you don't even know. This $1,000 purple lane, you don't even know. This $500,000 car, you don't even know.
Hey, man.
Yeah, yo.
Childish Major now is a real problem. I don't know if y'all know about this young nigga, man, but he got a lot of stuff going on, and I ain't even really. We got 30 minutes left, so we just gonna call this the Childish Major Hour. I want to give you to the world, man. Let everybody know, damn, what we got coming up next out this motherfucker, man.
Shit, man. Honestly, like, since then, I mean, the Jesus stuff came out. That was a blessing. You know, just people been calling. I really just been working on my pen game, just trying to make sure I'm perfecting the craft. I don't want to, you know, I never really just wanted to, you know, have no disrespect. I love what y'all do, but I know I wanted to do something different. So I really just been, you know, working on that and then working on my production game.
Well, do this for me. Play one of your records.
Hey, play one of them Jeezy guys.
Yeah, play that Jeezy record, then we want to hear some Childish Major. I want to hear what your bars like, B.
Oh. Let's see. It's the intro off of Seen It All.
I remember being posted up on the first and the third. Just read up, nigga got a 9-piece. Ay, all the while fantasizing, visualizing, coming through in the Benz with a dime piece. Yeah, all the mall with that time piece say. All the mall with that time piece say. No, it ain't shit sweet by the federal boot camp. Swim whipping like it's cream brulee. Straight drop that glass whipped cream. Watch them eat it up like dessert. Broad day, call it Dre. Almost caught me on the camera, nigga, make it a twerk. Imagine me with the Ken Moore stove, with the Pyrex going berserk. Show up in a khaki digging suit with the Timbs on, like I'm going to work. Like I'm going to work. That quarter block, all about getting that quarter block. Started with the rocks in the slab, then I moved up on the half. Hit him up with that quarter block. That quarter block, all about getting that quarter block. 250 straight, 9-piece straight drop. Yeah, I'm about to hit these niggas with a quarter block. I'm the undisputed track king, talking straight cash shit like Mayweather.
That's big.
Hey, man, appreciate it, man.
What else you got, man? I know you've been working with all the big dogs. Just play all the big dog shit first. I know you got to get, you want to come stun on everybody.
Man,
that's why I left you last, Childish, because you've been fucking shit up, niggas don't know.
Cut it out, man. Nah, I be working with my partners. It don't even be no shit like that, man. I fuck with who I fuck with, man. This a joint, man. This my artist and my best friend, you know, Matt Estrada. And then we got Big Crit and Curtis Williams on the record, too.
Dope.
And I'm singing on the hook. It's called Keep Running. Some hip hop shit.
Yo, Big Crit shout,
Big Crit shout,
Big Crit shout,
Big Crit shout.
Gotta keep running, 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 running.
Shit be real, this money is Achilles heel. Some break ankles to get it, torn ligament with it. Those knee droppers and pee poppers just to be Louis V shoppers with the sweet lobster. Bust it open to her precious middle, sound like beatboxes. And she wonder why we call her hoe. Cause instead of running laps, she running into laps. She lifts like Halle Berry and more like the Baps. Snap your fingers, no butlers, no genies. You could rub out of a bottle. You want it up out of college. Stop blaming your mom and father. For your mistakes, we all make them. You might not gamble with dice, but we all take them like 7-Eleven, or we crap out. Life can get a hold of your soul and make you tap out. Why you wanna pretend this ain't real when you should snap out of that dream state? How far would you walk for cheesecake? That's metaphoric for leaving your comfort zone. In case you wasn't born to see that show Diddy was on. Like, success might be around the bend. You can walk or run, but that's when the real race begins. Marathon, carry on, forever young. You'll never be, grow up and start parenting. The future joggers of this planet. Cause when your legs ain't strong enough, just pass the torch. Cause you can manage to keep running.
Let's see how your feet work. Let's see how your feet work.
Keep running, running,
and running, running,
and running, running,
and running, running, oh.
Let's see how your feet work. Let's see how your feet work.
Keep running, running,
and running, running,
and running.
Okay, Childish, I get it. I fucking get it now. So you're not from Atlanta, you're from South Carolina.
Yeah, South Carolina.
Explain your sound. Like, you're not really, like, you know, trappy.
I mean, I have elements, man. I learned so much from, I'm just glad to be here, but I learned so much from these guys around me.
He said something about the trip when we met, but, like, we took other trips, too. Like, I'll never forget, like, this was when you were still at your mom's crib. With the Fruity Loops,
yeah, yeah.
And all you, like, we was riding, listening to mainstream music, you was just in there listening to samples and old school, like, you had a rare cut since day one, you know what I mean? And really, just, I ain't get to expand on it, but Childish has one of the most unique sounds I've ever heard, ever, you know what I mean? Just, you know what I mean? I told you that before, but I just want to let everybody know, like.
Yeah, man, so, yeah.
That's where it came from.
It comes from that, you know, listening to old school music, man, just catching those vibes, man, listening to these guys are legends. You know, Pharrell's the inspiration, man, like, really just trying to take it there, you know. I play some more, like, my new shit. It's some shit, man. Shout out to Super Mario, man. He did that 2 cup stuff, but he been feeding me some shit lately. Got some shit, but yeah.
You and Super Mario going there?
Yeah, man.
Why? I gotta hear that.
There's some shit I did. It's called, like,
you on this record.
Yeah, yeah.
Exclusive.
Hey.
New
child's
magic. Go in the room,
too. Hey.
Let's get it.
She say she fucked the nigga to my song, and was trying to get it on and catch that feeling. But didn't feel it. I said, pull up on me, doll. I fuck your brains out. Matter of fact, I pick you up like I'm your man now. You play my shit in the ride. I fuck, staring in your eyes. I like you. Always better when I'm high. Got drunk, rubbing on your thigh. I like you. Yeah. Ain't none of your friends' business. Ain't none of your friends' business. What we do. Yeah. Ain't none of your man's business. Ain't none of my girl's business. What we do. I like. Keep it discreet. Hey, doing 35 in the 85. Trying to see what's up with a 6'9. Doing 35 in the 85. Trying to see what's up with a
6'9. Man, that child is major, man. If y'all, if any labels is watching this shit right now, he not signing to y'all. Fuck y'all.
Fuck y'all.
We don't need y'all. He got propane. You dig what I'm saying?
I like it.
So tell me about that, man.
Whenever I hear a producer who can go in the booth and lay some shit down like that, dude, along with you having your team, your engineer, you got managers, but man, you got to have your cool little video guy on the team.
Yeah, for sure.
You put a video to that, I promise you, dog, that should have changed your life. Because that's like, and it's still got that trap shit, but it's music.
Glad you fucking with it, man.
Man, that's that other shit, dog. Straight up. I fucks with that.
Keep going. This your last 30 minutes, man.
This my last 30 minutes. Oh, shit. Oh, I got some crazy shit with, shout to Curtis Williams and Matic. This was like a crazy night in the studio for me.
Childish Major. Exclusive shit, man. Y'all ain't heard this shit yet. Might not hear it.
It's some fun shit, man.
Shout to
T-Man. Can one of you guys say, can all three of you guys say pussy at the same time?
Alone, probably leaving with it.
Razor blade.
Hoes been on my dick cause they know I'm paid. But they but some good sex and some sniff from me. Probably smoke a blunt with them. And I'm just being blunt with them. Had a slumber party at the castle. Did the molly, put the bean in the asshole.
Cool though, I'm sorta like Cujo. Hoes tell me I'm a dog in the pussy, huh? All problems get solved in the pussy. Hit it like them pool hoes, have a ball in the pussy. Okay, cool. Got friends, know they do. Invite all them cabs over for a run, they fool. They pop molly, smoke inside exotic. Mama line the two, I won't knock it, not if we knocking the boo, started popping it, ooh. And I ain't stopping the fool, I'm just copping the fake. And she get up out of line, put that thot in the place, and that's real. Matter of fact, shawty come here, huh?
That's
crazy. I don't know if y'all witnessing this. We got Childish Major taking record advice from DJ Toomp, man. We don't get this all the time.
He's giving me great advice over here right now.
Make a ghetto version to that. It's that tempo to where it's
2-3 for ceiling. Boom, boom.
Still giving
crazy. That should be stupid because the way y'all riding that shit is already dope. Yeah. Yeah, I'm just enjoying the moment, man.
Appreciate
I'm
it, man. I'm glad y'all fucking with it.
Come on, Childish. What else you got, man? This your time, man.
Hey, man. This is artist.
Shout out to Shabazz.
From Cleveland. Her name is Laurentia. Super dope. She's like a soul artist. We did this shit. It's called Your Star. It's positive shit.
A lot of new music going on in this session.
Yes. It's about,
you can turn down a little bit.
It's about the way that you make them feel. People won't forget about the cards you deal. It's about your own. Don't go out to steal. Give the world some light with some sex appeal. Do it for yourself. You could have it all. Don't worry about the rest. Baby, you're a star. Baby, you can go anywhere you want. It's your world. Go ahead and live whatever you feel. Be who you are. Be yourself. Ain't nobody else can take on what you got. You're the only one. You're in charge. Baby, you're in charge. Know that you'll go far. Be yourself. Ain't nobody else what you are. What you are. Baby, you're a star. What you need is inside. Believe in your destiny. Go and live your dream.
That was dope, bro.
Appreciate it, man.
So that's a singer from Cleveland you're working with?
Yeah, it's a singer from Cleveland, man. She out here, though, man. Shout out to Lorraine. Thank you. This next one is Tracy T. Shout out to Tracy T. Shout out to Boosie, man. He hopped on this shit, man. It's so crazy.
Tracy T and Boosie, wow.
Tracy T and Boosie.
Is this out yet?
Yeah, it's out.
Oh, okay.
This one out, man. It's called Choppers.
About to say exclusive.
He like,
I love that word now.
He like, don't be just dropping shit.
I want to hear some shit ain't nobody heard yet. I want to be like, man, we was watching Boiler Room and them motherfuckers went crazy.
Is this going to be up for stream later? Like,
it's on. Yeah, it's going to stream for 7
to
12.
I mean, I know it's live, but I'm saying they're going to. Okay. He said watch it. This is Choppers, Tracy T, and Boosie.
Rollin' with another nigga, rollin' with a chopper.
Young boy.
Woo. Chopper. Clear the scene when I pull up with a chopper. Niggas bleed when I pull up with a chopper. Ain't no handguns, niggas tone chopper. Trey T roll with a chopper with a 100 in it. I can shoot 100 niggas if a nigga want it, he can come and get it. Come and get it. Shoot him up, nigga. We shoot shots. Around these dealers and robbers, these niggas, they tone choppers. Hey. My daddy, he a robber in the streets, yeah, he a OG, nigga. Fuck a pistol, got a chopper, 7.6 tools, make him bleed quicker. Rolling with a chopper, not the bitch, got the chopper, ride shot it, nigga. Heard a boom, boom. If you're rolling with a chopper, nigga, don't hesitate to use it. If you're rolling with a chopper, you don't squeeze it, motherfucker, you dead. Got a chopper about the size of me. Still a stutter when I spit it. Got too many shots for me to miss it. Clear the scene when I pull up with a chopper. Niggas bleed when I pull up with a chopper. Chopper, 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 chopper.
I like to welcome.
Fat Man Key in the building. Fat Man Key. Hey, man, say what's up, Fat Man Key.
What's good, Key?
Hell yeah, going on.
Hey, you talking about Fat Man Key, man. Eastside shit, nigga. So, so if somebody wanted to work with you, Childish, like, you seem like you kind of open. How does a person, like, work with Childish Major if I wanted to?
Hit me up. If you see me out, say what's up. Not out much, but when you do see me out, say what's up.
You a ghost, nigga.
Yeah, I am a ghost, man. It's all good, though.
Yeah, so no, you're not going to get no Childish Major beats unless you know somebody that knows somebody. Call me, call Spinz. You dig what I'm saying? We know how to get to the youngin'.
We can figure it out.
You dig?
Yeah, but,
So where do you want to, like, take this to when it's all said and done? Like, you know what I mean? I know everybody want to make history, but what's your ultimate goal? You want to be the artist, the producer? What do you want to do?
I'm still figuring it out. I'm just keeping honest. I mean, I feel like a lot of these guys, they know exactly what they want to do. Like, my shit changes every day. And, you know, it's coming, though. I'm going to figure it out.
You got a lot of time. You still young, brother.
Yeah.
You're
younger,
man. Keep making hits.
I just want to make hot shit right now, though. We'll figure all the other shit out, though.
Close us out with something, man. Close us out with something epic, man. I know you got something crazy, man. You want the world to hear. The world need to know you did what you got, man. Boiler Room TV.
Why you put the pressure on like that, man? Hey,
come on, brother. You the young LeBron, brother. They say LeBron don't come through in the clutch. You are a clutch guy, though.
Ooh.
You dig what I'm saying?
I mean, I'm going to play some of my boy Matic shit.
Matic hard.
It's my guy. Appreciate it, man.
Boss.
There's some shit, man. There's some Toomp inspired shit, actually.
Oh, dude, that Toomp inspired.
Some Toomp inspired shit, man. He said, what is this? You know what I'm saying? Oh shit, I don't put the pressure on now. So
uh-huh.
That's all good.
Oh, I hear it already.
In this crucible, I set a crucial flow. I go well, stupid though, when you should know. It's like I'm certified, a nigga hot just serving pies. I got that pookie dope, New Jack City. This ain't no movie though, boy. I got a few sacks in me. Get the crew sacks, Fippy got pimpin' all in my combo. Speed is like two existence, got bitches all in the condo. And they screaming, me yamo. I just tell them, say strato. Picture perfect, I work it with such a purpose. She slurping in certain service, get service inserted. Now she like, oh my god. Donald Trump and hoes, I hit them once and you know they fire. Don't even notify, yeah, maybe she catch the drip. Hope that she bought a meat, hey. Cause I ain't gon' call the shit,
hey.
Giving your daughter dick ain't much of an ultimatum. Niggas be pocket watching, I need an ultra payment. Maybe then I can paint it, just how I imagine it,
hey.
All on that magic shit, way above average, hey.
That's crazy. So that's your guy, Matic, son.
That's Matic, man. Crazy.
Matic.
Shout out to Toomp. Yeah, yeah.
I'm gonna let the OG close this shit out, man. We got. I'm gonna let the OG close it out.
My words, shit, man. First of all, man, I can tell I'm in a room full of guys who, you know, passionate about this shit. Y'all love it. I could tell it was, you know, it was a hobby first, man, before we really knew it was checks attached to this stuff. I mean, definitely. Stay on top of your business. Continue learning more and more, you know. Even though we banging, we getting placements with artists and stuff now. To learn about moving it around and getting you know, film placements. Yeah, diversify a little bit. Scoring, that's my next move. I'm slowly getting into that. But I'm finding out that it's more than just creating. You got to, it's a different thing when you got a director grabbing your music and putting it to scenes But when they send you a scene with no music and you have to put something to it, that's the fucking challenge. That's a challenge. You know what I mean? Because we can easily go through our folder and be like, oh, I'm going to send this director a folder. And he can get real creative with scenes. But when they send you something, that's that next level of score. I learned that from, you know, shout out to Salon Remy. He was putting me up on how serious that was. So, you know, just continue learning more and more about it, man. You know, the game itself. Because the more and more you learn, the more checks that going to come with it. Because you feel, you know, you know how to actually approach a situation when somebody, a director or whatever. Because Atlanta's about to be flooded with directors for sure. I don't know if y'all really know. Like, it's really, it's not just a, yeah, it's not just going to be somebody just passing through. You know, when LaFace came, it came and went. You know what I mean? You know, it was a run, but that TV and film shit,
it don't go
man,
nowhere.
Dude, that's going to be here, dude. That's why all these trees getting cut down, man. There's jobs, Porsche moving here, Mercedes to move here. It's like a lot of money coming here. So, boom, that's why I was talking about with them checks. Move that shit, grab you some property, buy some land. Never, you know, because the real estate shit going to be here forever. You know what I mean? But that's what I'm saying. But definitely when these directors and film producers come here, start talking to you about these TV shows and, man, I love to hear some of your music rolling in this. You need to know, hey, okay, if my song play at least 20 seconds, boom, that's a $50,000 check. You know what I mean? That sync fee is the shit. Hangover, me and Kanye, when they play that Can't Tell Me Nothing, I heard it was in the movie, but when I saw it, I was like, oh, we straight. You know what I mean? So that's something else, like, along with us chasing artists, you know, trying to get on cast projects, yeah, try to get on some of these movies too, man. And that's the good thing too, is to move your catalog around just on the licensing. The licensing game is something else too. So, boom, you may have 10 placements with artists, but shit, man, if you're playing on like 5 or 10 good movies out here, you know what I mean? Boy, the checks is incredible, you know? So, and to really, for that to go smooth, you want to understand the laws and everything that come with that too. That way you really, really know what you're supposed to be getting. So that's why I definitely advise you. You know, we, even though we got our attorneys who handle a lot of stuff, but ain't nothing like learning it yourself, because we steadily bringing other producers under our wing. So you want to be able to tell, educate him on royalties and licensing and all that. So you know, in order to pass that game on, it ain't like you gonna hook him up with your attorney to say, hey, man, my attorney will teach you how the game go. Fuck that. You need to know at least 40% book sense. You know what I mean? And just understand the whole thing, you know, of how it really, really goes. And just, you know, study the chapters that's, you know, that suits you. You know what I mean? Because the book is kind of thick, and I don't plan on reading the whole shit unless I'm really going to go that far into it. But for what we doing, definitely know the ins and out of that. Because I still got cats hitting me sometimes, you know. Have songs on the radio, and then you got these so-called CEOs who may have something going, hey, man, I just signed this producer. I'll be like, oh, yeah, what you doing? Well, man, honestly, man, I signed them. You know, I got my production company, but how am I supposed to get paid off this shit, too? I'm like, bro, are you for real? You really calling yourself a CEO and asking me how you supposed to get paid? Like, you abusing the name CEO, man. Hold on for you. Get into that. You know what I mean? Everybody's not cut out to start a record, you know, to be in the record business, especially if you haven't danced in this shit yet. You know what I mean? We could do that because we understand how records come together. We done played around the industry, but when you got somebody who's never done this shit just popping up just because you got bread, talking about he's a CEO, but still asking you how he's supposed to get paid, that's a problem, man. And that's what kind of it's fucking the industry up a little bit, because it's so easy to jump in. You know what I mean? One of your cats fresh out, you know, who might have a little 500 buried over his mom's house somewhere in the country. Figure I can start a label, but he don't even know what the rules or nothing to get. He haven't even picked up a book or nothing. So when you know more than this so-called CEO, see, you're going to end up making more than him, because he don't know what the fuck he's supposed to be getting. So keep on educating yourself, man, and keep banging. I love what I'm hearing. How y'all feel about the EDM, man? Do you think that it's a way that we can introduce a little bit of that with what we're doing to where rappers will feel comfortable fucking with it? What y'all think? Because I haven't seen, I mean, even though we make music that make people move, but, oh, man, it's something about the energy in that where I would love to incorporate that with what we're doing, because, dude, that Tomorrowland, Tomorrow World shit, like, there's been no hip-hop event nowhere near that. I don't care, you call a summer jam, birthday bash, all that, but there's nothing that we've ever had in the hip-hop. So I'm trying to figure out what can we do to create, recreate our own thing to where we can have a true movement like that? Because I'm trying to figure it out. I could tell you could DJ very well. I could DJ very well, but ain't nobody finna give us no $20,000. So we talking about 20, but now you got cats get 200,000.
I did two EDM tours with Flostradamus, who are, you know, they're, you know, big name EDM act or whatnot. But what they really did was they definitely borrowed a lot from our culture. But what's been going on is EDM's been going on as long as we've been making trap music, as long as hip hop, all that shit been going on is dance music. You know what I mean? So what they did
here,
yeah, what this new wave of people are doing is they're taking elements from ours and blending it. You know what I'm saying? But it hasn't been, like, trap hasn't been touched in dance music until now. So that's why you get that peak of what's going on. Like, they, and you know, you can look at it a thousand different ways, but I have to salute them because, shit, that's.
I definitely salute them.
Yeah, not taking nothing away from nobody, but it's just, it's like they innovate. They didn't directly innovate it, but they took it and they remixed it.
Right.
And they're profiting off of it. So until another wave or something that we do or we blend with comes together, and I feel it will. You know what I mean? But that's just one edition of it. Like,
I think the first thing we're gonna have to do is let motherfuckers know it's cool to dance again too.
Boy, what?
Yeah.
What? Amen. Amen.
Motherfuckers act like they too cool to move nowadays. I feel crazy when I'm dancing. Yeah, cause I mean in our culture we're here the hardest beat, but still.
Yeah, I don't go to the club.
And you can't, you know, it don't really go but so far if everybody's too cool, because that's what plays a part with EDM is the fact that
they don't give a fuck.
Yeah, they jumping around, they wilding. But we was there at one point too, though.
Absolutely, you know? We got
to
get back.
Because it reminds me of the energy that we used to get when we used to throw on some Clay D. It's a Two Live Crew, that up-tempo. That shit used to make some of the most conservative girls, women, just go on that fucking floor and just lose it, dog. And that's when it was real cool to dance. Then I'm over throwing some smooth, slow shit. Do we spit your game? You can't get a slow dance, slow song for nothing, maybe at a house party. So what I'm saying is, some kind of way, I think we can really take our shit to the next level, but I don't know. We may play a part in that. Like I said,
we can change it.
Yeah, I saw them move people, but it just don't make them wild the fuck out. Like that, and I don't know what it's gonna take. We might have to just do it. I don't know. Turn the DJs
Facts.
Or some shit.
We gonna
I don't
do
know.
It.
Yeah. Wait, it's over too fucking cool, right? Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I fuzz with A-Track. I met him when I was dealing with Kenya. Yeah. Yeah. Either embrace what they doing or get what we have already. And try to incorporate something to where it's gonna, like you say, make people just a little bit looser, man. Cause right now everybody's so cool, man. And I, you know, in our culture, they too fucking cool. Yeah, man. Come on, man.
Well, I know this event today was cool, man. I appreciate y'all coming out, man. For real, man. Boiler Room, thank y'all for having us. Thanks for exposing us to the world. Shout out Boiler Room. We gonna do this again ASAP, man. Whenever y'all have us, man, we gonna do it again. You dig what I'm saying? Shout to my boy Morgan. Shout to Shabazz. Shout to Curtis Patchwork. You dig? I'm gonna turn up, man. C-Note. Damn, C-Note just walked in the building. What the fuck? Hey, turn the camera around. Look, C-Note. What the fuck? The Honorable C-Note is in the building. Hey. The motherfucker C-Note. Thank you all for coming out, man. You dig? Boiler Room. Anything? Any last word? All right, cool. See y'all next time. We out.